Live on Twitch for the very first time. Hi guys, welcome to the Irish Wrestling Podcast for our first watch along with Hard Knox Undisputed. Liz is back. She's fucking back.
Yes, bye, what a vengeance. The Queen is back and she is ready to rock this out. She's not 100%, so she might not be roaring much at this, but I was absolutely sickened, literally, that I missed this show. I was buzzing for it and the card, unbelievable. And I haven't watched it. I'm the only one here who has not watched it and I'm dying for it. I cannot wait. I have to try to keep the drama under control to make sure I don't duck in again, but you know, I'll try.
Jerry, how are you fixed?
I'm good, yeah. I can't wait to watch it. We're just about to kick off the Hard Knocks show here, Kings of the North against the Pretty Sexy Playboy. So looking forward to seeing what it's like not sitting on the commentary desk.
I'm watching as a fan, and I'm, do you know what I mean? Because I said I didn't have any commentary and he hadn't seen anything.
We just say that Mark was meant to be here as well, but he decided to fuck off and go to ICW. Was it the ICW after party or something he's gone to?
Yeah, Progress ICW show at the For Love of Wrestling over Manchester. So he's,
we're not jealous at all, are we?
He's mingling with a lot of people.
He says he is, but he got wind of me coming on this after taking my commentary seat and he was like, oh, I'm busy. Yeah, keep running, Mark. Right. Love you.
The show is live on YouTube. I think we're a couple of minutes behind, but we are going to kick off now. And anyway, so I will be stopping music and stuff because we don't want to get DMCA'd, obviously, on our first night. That would be fun. Imagine the account getting deleted. So I apologise for intros and stuff, our entrances that will be muting or lowering down so that we can't hear them. But yeah, I'll try to be on the ball with it and get the sound back as quick as possible. But yeah, I think we're good to go. Right, away we go.
No, I was just asking, yeah, so we're going from the very start.
Yeah, do you want to count then so we're on the same level? Sorry, guys. So just
go back to chat. We're not going to catch
Yeah, Liz and Jerry have to watch on their iPads. They have two devices, so we need to count them in.
What's a Twitch?
What's a Twitch?
You're getting around, you're like, back off, just mind your business.
Hold my poodle.
Right, from the start, you ready to go?
Go.
Right, 3, 2, 1, play.
We have to mute that music.
I think we're all right with this music. I think. All right.
I'm sorry now, right? I know we're biased, but how can you not be 109% obsessed with, like, when you switch this on, how can this not lift you up and get excited for what you're about to see? I love the intros to the shows. They're just obsessed. I'm obsessed. Biased, but I don't care. I'm just obsessed. I love it. Presentations, everything. Look at him, there's my guy, look at the snake, look at him!
I think I have to turn this down, unfortunately. I don't know, were you allowed to play it if people are actually playing the song that's not actually the song?
Not sure, because I suppose it's a cover, isn't it? But look, if we have to, we have to. I'm sure we'll be told fairly quickly. Live music with the Kings of the North, what an impact.
The live music did make it. It was deadly. Mm. I'm sorry I can't play it on stream. I'm really sorry.
No, there's 5 seconds of Jeopardy.
We have Laura in the chat as well. She said that we're early, or we started early, which we probably did. Apologies.
It's only an entrance. You haven't missed much. Introduction to the snacks, popcorn with melted caramel nibbles.
Laura's in the chat there. She's just saying we may be a little bit early. I'm not sure.
Callum is just saying.
A little bit behind, or
I think Jerry's a little bit behind.
Yeah, there will be. There's always a delay from the show until switch on it. But sure, look at.
All right, the dog is eating my toes. I'm a little bit distracted.
Your toes are in the way of the dog.
I don't know. Not chewing on my tongue.
Was this our first tag opener? Did we have a tag opener before? I don't think we did.
I think it must be who opened the first show.
Was it the Triple Threat was the first one?
Yeah. It was. And wasn't the last one Steve and Sammy? And then it went on to...
Did Steve and Sammy open the last one?
Not Steve and Sammy, that was the one prior, wasn't it?
No, Triple Threat opened the first ever
show. Yeah, Scotty was the first man out, I think, wasn't he, in the first show?
Before the match, they had a face-off. Shout out for Foxy's polo shirt. How nice and clean is the design of the Hard Knox polo shirt?
It's definitely a nice change. Like.
Yeah, it's nice to see him out of stripes, isn't it?
Yeah. I think it just adds that extra kind of aesthetic that, like, it's different. I think NLW do it as well, where they have their NLW shorts as well. Like, I think it just makes it that little bit different. It's like, this is, it's not just your standard wrestling show. This is Hard Knocks or this is NLW or whatever you're going to see, like.
Danzo.
Yeah.
I hope Pretty Sexy Playboys know what they've left themselves in for, like, I'm a whisper.
I hope people are showing up to his Foxy seminars as well. If you're not, you're missing out on.
Oh, what a source of knowledge. Mm. Like, there's nothing Foxy doesn't know. Because you could learn so much from him, like, so he has one to be gone.
We were hoping we'd get him on this because he knows everything about Twitch. And we know
And for Laura, just cola. Laura, even enough for the two of us, don't worry. Jerry was making it and I was like, a bag each. Go away with your bag between us. Two boys have come out here with a
tremendous amount of aggression to start things off. Four big meaty men here as well.
Just slapping the meat by.
It's like a Sheamus and Gunther style match. Like, it's so hard hitting.
Yeah. Bye forever. For Sheamus and Gunther, I could watch it day in there. The hottest high team in Europe right now. He's an artist, just pure not taking these boys seriously at all. Like,
I think they're right as well. Like,
I love it. Oh, come here. Imagine coming into the Kings of the North and telling them that you're from the greatest country in the world.
Imagine still thinking Great Britain is a country.
No, we don't cancel
it.
Yeah,
don't start now because
it's a
Jerry,
union, not a country.
There,
England's a country.
You can't stop it now.
Kill that to the Scottish in the well.
Put your hand on.
Nah.
Yes, Laura, you do need to come to Limerick. You do need to get to a show. You're dead right. Everyone needs to get to these shows. This show was the best of the three so far, in my opinion, and a lot of other people's opinions. So, yeah, like, if this show isn't the one that's going to fire you up to get to Limerick, none of them will, like, because, like, you don't know what you're missing. Like, the feel in the venue and all is ridiculous. Like,
it's not different. It's just, I don't know what it is. It takes that love that you have for wrestling all the time that no one will ever take serious, only you.
Mm.
And you feel like you're in a room of like-minded people and everyone's just there for the buzz. And those who aren't fans, they just get so swept and caught up in it and love to hate those who they don't like. And, you know, it's just, and they really root. And even from the first show, we were like, what in the name of Christ is this? We were blown away at the first show and hungry for more. Unreal. One for
Jordan Sparks as well. Jordan's tan is on point, isn't it?
Yeah.
gotta love a good tan, lads. There's only one tan I'm a fan of in wrestling. Only one.
CBL.
CBL tan. Best farmer's tan I've ever seen in my life. You couldn't get it if you tried.
Wait till later on in the show and you'll see what his tan
looks like. You got your farmer? Oh, I love it. Brilliant.
It's epic.
Spoiler one in there.
Spoiler.
It wasn't announced, Jerry. Don't be giving the game away.
Not really. Spoiler. CBL. If you haven't seen him perform and haven't seen his farmer's tan. Damien, it looks like
he was born to perform for Hard Knocks. You're the man who sits next to the Christmas tree watching the child open the presents you said you'd never get in your sack there like that, gun.
Yep.
That's you. Stop spoiling.
Laura, that getting home issue doesn't seem to be a problem with Hard Knocks now because I don't know if you're in Dublin or not, but this last show stopped just in time for everybody to get on the last bus.
The bus
stopped.
That was
Dublin,
right. So. How considerate is that, though?
Yeah.
Do you know?
They wanted more people coming, so...
Yeah. Yeah, well, at least they weren't too big for the boots and were like, fuck them. Do you know, they were like, do you know what? We started a bit earlier. People, if they want to stay for a few drinks afterwards, they can. Or, you know, if you need to jump in the bus, they'll go. So.
Or if you're driving people home to Dublin, like Colin was, you can stay until whatever time you want.
Oh! I would not like to be on the under end of a narc chop, would you?
No.
No. A pork chop, maybe.
Another one for a good measure. Yeah, bone saw chops are vicious.
Like, that's an arm and a half coming at you at a very fast speed, you know. So this is pure experience now. They're just teaching them, like, it's like they're teaching them a lesson now, you know, because they're like, yeah, let's come on away over here, but we'll really show you what's going on. Jesus, I'm baiting through this hopper. The pretty sexy playboy is taking control here now. If the pretty playboys thought this was going to be an easy
afternoon, as quick as that, it's after turning back again. I just noticed some of the lads there sitting down in the front row. I didn't even know they were there. Jordan and
did you not know? No,
I didn't see them at all that day at all. I didn't know they were there.
Ah, they're all hooked now as well. I was talking to the lads there.
Oh yeah, the boys
all hooked. They loved it. Absolutely loved it.
Rob wasn't there, was he?
No. Was he? No, Rob wasn't there. I think he just bitched out. Oh, sorry, he was away to, he was flying out the next morning. I think he had like a 7 a.m. flight or something. He went over to 1PW and Riot, I think, were the two that he went to.
I love how Foxy's nearly getting the chops as well. He makes my day watching him wreck. Big backdrop,
beautiful Sayido suplex. Synchronized. Bonesaw there.
What? Walk up to 2 pounds. Oh, you're for it now, boy. Bonesaw's pointing, you're for it. The viciousness of this match has taken the crowd by surprise. Oh, nice. I think a lot of people, maybe first-timers here, are a bit surprised by how... One way to take a big man out like that, though, is you've got to come up with something fucking out the box, don't you?
You got to outsmart them. Yeah. Never going to outpower them.
Look at the size of the two boys as well. Like, you don't realise how big they actually are until they're in there with two big guys like Bonesaw and Corvin. Like,
yeah.
Like, they're big fuckers, like... Pity the two lads. They were in the back of my car from Dublin. And,
pretty sexy playboys. Oh, and Bits going home, I'd say.
Yeah, like, there was five of us in the car as well, so they had no room to stretch out whatsoever, like.
Oh, Christ. Crippled when they got out. Pretty playboys endearing themselves
to the crowd even further, obviously. Although, I think they got put up in Limerick. They went back with me, so they got put up in Limerick for the night, I think. So I hope they had a nice rest and all that night before having to travel back to Dublin for a flight home, but...
Okay.
Two good lads as well, really big wrestling fans.
Solid tag team though, like you can see they're going to go somewhere. Like,
oh, chemistry,
yeah. They do like tag team wrestling how tag team wrestling should be done, like it's proper tag team wrestling, you get me? Like,
that makeshift shit, like, you know, you can tell when you've got a nicely gelled tag team, you can tell.
Like the quick in and outs, isolating their opponents, very, very simple. When it like wrestling is best done when it's kept simple, and they do it so simple, but it's so effective as well, you know. After being a little bit off in the early stages
with the Kings taking control, the pretty sexy playboys are definitely. Yeah, Laura's in it. It was PW that Rob was at. Oh, nice.
Huge German suplex from Bonesaw. No, there mustn't be any direct. She's in that alone.
Down to the weekend. Down for to Limerick for the weekend. So.
Not there will be a direct from bus or train. No train that one, but like a bus or something that will go there.
Yeah, I think that there used to be, they cancelled a lot of trains, I think, around the country that used to run. Like, so there used to be a Waterford to Limerick link and stuff and all that doesn't run anymore.
Yeah.
Nice.
Like Transport for Ireland, they're after coming in now. They're making great strides with the transport around the country, so hopefully in the next couple of years it's a lot more accessible.
Better, yeah.
Let's get a train into Donegal. the only county in the whole country. Well, on that loop. Stops in Derry.
And you know what?
If you go on Sligo.
The way things are going with Hard Knocks, they'll be coming out in Limerick pretty soon.
I'm just after getting an overhead view of the canvas, and I've never noticed it before, but just that overhead view, it's very bare. I didn't realise how bare it is. I think a nice big logo in the middle of it would be nice.
Like sponsorship of like Irish Wrestling Entertainment.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I hope you have enough money to cover that with Steve D.
Manscaped.
Your balls, well, thank you.
Yeah, I didn't realise how bare the canvas actually was, because you can't see it at that angle, like from where we're sitting. Yeah. So it's not bad, like, but like definitely a nice big logo in it would be nice. I like the banners at the side of the ring though. Did you notice them at the front of the ring?
Yeah. I think first show looking down from the balcony on commentary from the first show. You didn't really notice.
Yeah, I didn't. Yeah.
Big win for the Kings there, like.
Never a doubt. Pretty deadly boys needed a spanking though, to be fair, didn't they? Like, they've been, remember they were over the first show, they were over against Kelly August Lynch.
Yeah.
And they were just like,
oh, look at this.
Oh.
This is new.
Oh, replay.
I like that.
Yeah.
That's still a hard cam, is it?
That's good. Yeah, I think that's the hard cam, yeah. Yeah, Laura, they're very good, and I don't think it's going to be the last time that we see them. Like, they're a good team, and yeah, they'll definitely be back over. I think they worked with Steve over in the UK. That's how Steve got to know them. Steve worked with them on a few loops in the UK and said to them at the first show, do you want to come over? Do you want to work Hard Knocks? So, yeah, good team to have over.
Yeah.
And the respect shown there as well is it's great to see. Like, that's... Yeah, that's a great rub from the Kings to the two boys as well, you know.
Not to them. Oh my God, like, you will get far more, far little you'll get the more respect, more respecting.
Fan cam. I love this. Fan cam.
Love this. At DMC Visual. Obsessed with this.
Yeah, I like that.
That's cool.
Good, isn't it? Yeah. It's just something different, isn't it? Like something that you don't.
You get a chance, your content gets to go on the show. Like,
yeah, yeah. And like, hopefully that's good for the people who are doing it. Like, might entice people to get their phones out a bit and record a bit of the show. Like. We don't apologise for any language on the show, by the way. Listen, me and Jordan, we like to come out of here and take the piss out of all of you because it's easy. It is easy. I don't like King Charles that much. He's a bit of a cunt. What a line. What a line. Listen, me and Jordan, we love wrestling in Limerick. We love wrestling for Hard Knocks.
We thought we were going to come in and run over everybody, but Ireland's got some pretty stiff fucking competition. Damn right we do. So that's why we're going to be excited to be back when Hard Knocks debuts their tag team championships. We'll be fighting for it. Tag team titles.
There it is, Colin.
Oh, look at this. Look at that. Nice.
We're getting
Hard Knocks. Beautiful. Love presentation. And a pretty sexy playboy has said that they'll be back for them. This isn't the last time that we're going to see them. Possibilities are endless with those tag team titles, aren't they?
Yes. And hopefully they can, like, get the prestige of them up as well, like, and have teams that want to come to Hard Knocks.
You need people like me, so say goodbye to the Cowboy!
Love a bit of CJ West.
CJ's unbelievable. He done all this himself, like, yeah.
Yeah.
Amazing.
Did you bring the product? That's some good product.
They are shiny, Laura, you're
right. Shiny tag team titles, Laura.
You did good, kid. You stick with me, we'll go places.
thing you gotta understand is the world is yours. You just gotta go and take it.
Limerick City. How does that
sound? That is such a fucking Miami fucking Vice vibe, I tell you. It's just amazing.
Yeah, I think it's Vice.
Felix Love Child, isn't it?
Took a straight cross between Vice City, Grand Theft Auto, and Scarface, and yeah, proper 80s American shit.
Oh, it is, yeah.
Again, I don't know if that song's allowed, so I apologize.
Obsessed with my shoes.
So a little tidbit about her shoes, actually, while I have the music down. She actually had them shoes at Scrapper. And so she wore them on the Friday night, Saturday night, Sunday, because she did the 3 days. She forgot to turn them on Friday and Saturday. So if you actually go back and watch OTT Wolverhampton and OTT Dublin, the Scrappermania shows, you'll actually see she doesn't have the colours on them, but they are the same shoes. She just forgot to turn them on both times.
Right. They're amazing.
And did she know on the Friday she forgot to turn them on, and then she forgot again on the Saturday?
Yeah. So I told her... I was saying to her, if I don't see them on Sunday, I'll give you a shout. But she did. She had them on the Sunday. Shoes are deadly, though.
Yeah.
I don't know how they work. If they, like, it looks... I don't know if they change on their own or if they change when she moves them or hits them or...
Be a setting or something.
They're deadly, though. They're deadly. Oh, she has to charge them as well, is another thing. So she says she might forget to charge them. No, I know that.
Minute. Liz, just hang them. On. Let's just take it in.
So I know that this song is DMCA'd because I put it up on YouTube and I got a copyright violation on YouTube for it. How are Hard Knox getting away with it? How are they not getting a copyright restriction on it?
I'm not sure how that works whenever any promotion puts up their content, and the entrance music is all copyrighted. I don't know how it works.
See, I don't know how much it's restricted. I think it might just be some countries, like, but it's not in its entirety.
I put up some videos and has music in it, and it says restricted in certain countries. Like,
yeah, I've gotten a few of them. Jay's jacket is class, though, isn't it?
Gorgeous.
I love that jacket.
Some silver vibes in that Gruig. Maybe it's just the lighting, but. Maybe Foxy Johnny's hair. Hashtag Silver Fox. Daddy's home! Look! Daddy's home!
Somebody shouted, fuck you, Sammy, there again, in the background. Folks,
we do not apologize for bad language.
Wow. Jerry Sammy not apologizing like again.
Absolutely not.
When you're swearing, though, it's normally me.
I'm not this, I'm on that. We never apologize for things.
Acknowledge him.
I definitely dropped a few F-bombs on commentary that night.
A couple of holy shits and...
Session Macho's got the ink.
But tonight the draw's here on serious business. This is a joke of a town...
Commands around, doesn't he? Like, love him or hate him. Like, when the mic is in his hand, like, people listen, like...
Love him. I'm sorry now.
What a joke of a champion. There's only one world champion in this country, and you're fucking looking at him.
Sammy,
hello,
Sammy.
Sammy. Cool. Hello.
Sammy being the OTT world champion.
The camera in your screen.
Let's not forget, Sesshamot Martina is also a world champion in this country.
Absolutely, even though she doesn't have the belt with her.
Let's not talk about the order.
We won't.
Martina, you've been doing this for 10 years. You're 40 years old. Go home.
That's ageism. Wow.
Age is just a number.
CJ's reaction.
For 10 years, calling out, shaking your jiggly arse.
Dying inside.
Your jiggly arse. Jesus, Sam.
At the end of the day,
Martina, I forgot he said that.
You're just a dirty, dirty skank.
Oh, now.
Sammy certainly knows how to talk to a woman.
Deserved. Well deserved.
Absolutely deserved slap.
Oh my God. I forgot I even said that in common.
I don't know, lads. I think Martina will be chasing him around the playground, and I think Sammy will be pulling her kicks in.
Thank God. Thank God. This Sammy's opponent for later on tonight. And a number one contender match out with the same running Sammy
awesome,
and
right? How lovely is Leighton Buzzard?
He's the best.
Yeah.
Right?
He's so nice.
Like, ridiculously talented. He's just super nice. Like, almost as nice as Big Demo. Almost. But, like, Big Demo. Big Demo, he's set, like, very high man. We love him. We love him.
It's the ACW stuff.
Yeah. The energy by.
There's a, oh, these people there's a certain know individual that I've just ever seen is just currently League watching. That just went running out of ring.
Oh, really? Hello. Welcome to the show. Somebody is watching.
I think that's him.
And Sammy, you wanna come if it's him, here, you know what to do. Well, leave a little comment. If anybody else is watching, you
back in, Sammy, just bait that off him.
Back away. You're gonna see exactly what happens when the snake
steps into the ring with the buzzard, because you're gonna be looking. Oh, Laura, we just got her a little while ago. It's split. Fucking sun's out again now, but we got an absolute torrential torrent there.
Slashing here.
Been misty all day, like.
Yeah, it's been threatening.
It's been lovely here all day. Then you just start pissing out an hour.
What's the background? I've been gardening there this afternoon. And it was just Sammy D, Kurt, mist just wouldn't go away. It's like main event. It is the night of debuts. Leighton Buzzard's making his debut. And within 5 seconds, he's got the delivery crowd.
What an addition to Hard Knox's roster. Leighton Buzzard, like, you just doesn't matter where you turn, he's somewhere, isn't he?
Look at him with
just
the hat, look.
I will reverse my vengeance.
El Baseball Capitan.
Laura's saying Leighton's come a long way there since ICW. Absolutely, Laura, and like, I can guarantee you he will not be, like, if he won't be here next year. He's gonna be snapped up by somebody, like, he's so good.
He'll either be in Japan with the United Empire, or he'll be in AEW.
That's a good shout, actually. Like, I think his style is so good, he could wrestle anywhere.
Yeah.
You know, I don't think he'd be hampered by anything. I can see him in a WWE. I can see him in an Impact, an AEW, in New Japan. Like, he's just that good. Like.
Yeah, I'd love to see him in Japan either with United Empire or against United Empire. Like, Hammond.
I think that they're after bringing Dan Maloney in. I don't know if they'd be open to bringing someone in again so quickly. Like,
I wouldn't put him in the Bullet Club, but I'd definitely have him in Japan, maybe for a quick run, like, or do the Super Juniors or something.
Yeah, so this match as well, like, this getting four gold, the winner getting four golden tickets, like, it's coming towards the end of our golden ticket tournament.
Mark trying to figure out how to turn the microphone on there.
That was brilliant. He's like, how do I do this? Press the button, Mark. Flip the button. Wait, where's the button?
If Liz was there, she would have turned it on.
And I'm not being funny now. Look, I didn't say it, all right. But
it was LJ as well. He's like, he goes, do you have a mic? And Mark hands him the mic and he goes, can you turn it on for me? And Mark's like, I don't know how to turn it on. He's like, yeah, neither do I. And then he turned around to me, how do I turn it on?
Why do you think we would let him sit in that seat?
See, I did want to sit on that side. I usually sit on the outside of the desk. But Mark is actually deaf in one ear. So he actually had to sit on that side. So me and Jerry were the other side in his good ear. Like.
Yeah, good ear. I can't believe he didn't leave my chair empty as a mark of respect.
Liz, anyway, seriously, come on. Mark of respect. We should,
the next one is great. I know, but like...
We should have got a little sign or something and put it on the desk, Jerry, shouldn't we?
I think we should.
Do you know what to do? Get a cardboard cutout. Exactly. And a little crown on the top of it and a big smile.
Oh, imagine.
And I'll be there.
Your daddy's home!
Thanks. That was a shit poor impersonation of me. And disrespectful to Limerick Static. Just saying.
And I'll say, maybe my first two wins for these weren't
My best. I was
definitely weren't his best.
My best foot forward.
Mm-hmm. No, he was taking the piss of it.
Totally. Warm ups, NG. Warm ups.
But whatever about me not putting my best foot forward, what really got to me was people telling me that the wins were easy.
They were easy.
Because exactly what nothing we said. I've ever done in my 10 years in pro wrestling has been easy. You can't do easy and then become the MVP of Irish wrestling.
That's right.
So tonight I take on three the best, Anita Vaughn, one of the current.
What a show she had at the previous Hard Knocks, didn't she?
Yeah.
Oh my gosh. Was it Unbroken, wasn't it?
Unbroken, yeah.
Oh my god.
Don't get me started on the other names of the shows. I only said this to the lads. I was like, can you please stop calling them Un something? Because they just get so confused and I can't remember which one is which. He'd be tripping over myself.
Followed Hard Knocks, so we were good.
Yeah. Best foot forward. But she didn't believe it. See her thick boots in the
off. Yeah.
Oh, Laura, this is your warning now. 30th of July. Hard Knock. Unlock. Hard Luck.
I'm already there.
In Limerick. Try your best to get there.
I swear to God.
Ridiculous.
Oh, yeah, we have the first two tickets.
Wheel me up there. You wheel me up there and I will commentate with a drip from my bed.
Jerry, we have the first two tickets for that show as well. Like, first two tickets available. Anyone wants them, go into our previous video, comment in the video. If this goes up on YouTube, you can comment here as well, I suppose.
Yeah.
Why not? This is your chance. But as soon as we hear that tickets are gonna go on sale, we're gonna take everyone who commented and we're gonna throw them into a draw and that person will win the first two tickets.
And maybe something else.
You're not a fan of Anita Vaughn, Laura, no?
But you know what, love her or
are
hate
you
her
Colin?
Yeah. Well, no, sorry now Colin, you'll back me up here. Love her or hate her, has she not had a ridiculous 12 months?
Unbelievable.
I'm sorry, she has like just oh,
one of the hardest workers in the country, like hands down.
Oh, hello. Oh, Francis.
Oh, here he comes, Mr. fucking negativity coming into the chat.
It's an elimination process.
Keep it clean, Francis.
Last man standing walks away with our woman in
yeah, so first two start here. Every 5 minutes, someone new enters, and last person standing gets four tickets.
But again, pinfall, submissions, countouts, disqualifications can take
maybe
place at any time.
We should do something with the two tickets we have for Hard Knocks.
Hunger Games.
I stood with like 12 women at a wedding to catch the bouquet where I met Jerry, and I beat the shit out of a lot of them. I knocked bitches out of the way, mate, because I had a damp on this guy, and I did. I didn't give a fuck.
I was like, this is brilliant.
Yeah, that was brilliant, and I came out with a bouquet, boy. Absolutely. I could train the four of them that are left, and I'd be like, look, when they do this, do that. Come here, won, didn't I? Who was the real winner, though, love? Who was the real winner?
Wrestling.
Definitely you.
I like the clock here, Jerry. What did you make of it?
Yeah.
I like that. We didn't get to see that, but it only popped up on the big screen. On the hard, or the big monitor in the back, on the 10-second mark, I still.
Really?
Good to see this.
Wait till Hard Knocks was a rumble. It's just, I don't know, I know we always say Hard Knocks hits different, but it just does, and I just.
Yeah, LJ liked it.
I just think you see different sides to some of the best wrestlers in Ireland when they're in Hard Knocks. Yeah. It's just different. It's a different vibe, and I love it. Not that there's anything wrong with any of the other vibes, but it's just so nice to, you know, in so many different promotions, to see so many different sides of wrestlers. And it can't help but fine-tune their skills and, you know, mic skills, their presentation, their ring awareness. It's just a beautiful thing to watch.
I think it's something that we're I spoke about this before, but something that we're very lucky with in this country, that like every promotion has its own little niche, its own little USP that they offer. It's no two are the same, like they're all very different. I just think it's great, like
even the presentation of them, like none of the shows look the same.
Yeah.
None of them.
Yeah.
So you really feel like you're seeing something else.
Definitely working on that left arm.
What I like about all the schools in Ireland, or all the promotions, is the school factor that, you know, you work your ass off from in the school and you'll get on to the show.
Yeah.
Whether it's Hard Knocks, Next Gen, you know, Contenders, whatever it turns out to be.
Mm-hmm.
There's always a spot somebody can work their ass off and be on the show and show off what they can do.
Yeah. Like not only to get to train, you know, along with, I mean, if you're starting out in pro wrestling now, like, obviously the goal is, you know, you want to main event something, but yeah, like, you want to get to the ring first. So can you imagine one of your idols in Irish wrestling is training alongside you? You've watched, been watching them, you know, taking a bit of a notice of it. They're training alongside you and you'll get to wrestle them and learn so much. It's just...
Yeah.
I'm sorry, but we have one of the best wrestling scenes in Europe. It's hands down, like, our talent are in demand.
There's one of the best coaches in Ireland in the ring right now, like, and, like, what is he, 23? Like, he's coaching, like, three different schools weekly, like, it's unreal, like, and the good thing about LJ is, like, when he's not coaching, so he coaches during the week, sometimes on a Saturday if he's not busy, but, like, when he's not coaching, he's usually in a foreign country or at a different school doing a seminar or doing a show, and he's picking up so much. And I've actually seen other coaches, and like even Phil spoke to us about this, which is something that will be coming out soon. Phil spoke to us about him coming back and like Phil learning stuff off him. Paddy said the same thing. Joe said the same thing. Joe does be asking him, like, oh, like Lee would do something in the ring and he'd be like, oh, where did you learn that? Show us that again. Like, you know, and it's just those little things. And
he's, everyone benefits.
So, but again, it's so young as well. Like,
he's sucking every, he's a, you know, student of the game. Like, he's sucking every bit of information out of it. Like,
yeah, but like imagine where he's going to be in 10 years.
I know, yeah.
Like, it's scary. Like, it's scary. And like he still has 10, 20 years left in 10 years' time. You know, it's mental.
Again, like both of us were talking earlier, like LJ is one of them people, like, you can just see him fitting in, like, in Japan or in, you know, a big American promotion. Like, got everything they need for it.
I can see him being pretty big in the industry as a whole. In the ring, we don't know where his in-ring career is going to go, but just because he's such a student of the game and he has so much experience at such a young age, like, I can definitely see him going on and being an agent, a producer in a wrestling company down the line. And being,
yeah, he'd definitely be involved in some capacity. Yeah. Like, he really, really would.
He loves wrestling as well.
The whole thing, yeah. You can see him in, like, a Jason Jordan role. Do you know what I mean? You can see him in, like, an Adam Pearce role. You really can, where, you know, not just an on-screen presence, but there's so, or even TJ Wilson, you know, really, like, backstage presence. And do you know where he'd be ridiculous at? NXT. To imagine, like, what he'd learn and what he'd bring, you know? Here we go.
Who have we got? I actually can't even remember.
Boots.
Look at it. Look at
it. You see a promo he put out today on Twitter? He was going around Grafton
Street. Yeah, I've seen it, yeah.
In a footwear. What's the best type of footwear?
Yeah. There's anyone else that. Look at boots. Look at them.
Straight back in with starting that little mini feel that he had with Anita from the last show.
Yeah. Oh, he's still upset because she picked him up and tossed him like a bag of fucking sand.
She's jacked. She's jacked as fuck.
Oh, God, yeah.
Absolutely, two fatigued opponents against a
four. Laugh boy, look at that. Heavy power moves. Love
that was a problem. Like, that's basically just giving them the middle finger, wasn't it? Like,
yeah.
Massive shoulders and the shoulder size advantage immediately. Boots Murphy.
He's very over, isn't he?
Yeah.
I love that he's over and that everyone's getting behind Boots. I love that.
And what's he, like, 12 months in the game?
Yeah, a little longer. I think he was in that group that started the end of 2021. Mm. I think it's around September, October 2021. So he's about a year and a half.
That's been her most effective move so far. Anita going for the slam. This worked the last time on Boot. That's how she won the last time
against Boot. He's too fresh now, Anita. Give him another few wallops there, girl. He's way too fresh.
Not a wise idea, Colin. We know she can get him up. She did it the last show. We know she can get him up, but just not yet.
Making me want to get a new pair of boots. In fact, I might wear boots to the next one.
Oh, there you go.
Yeah, there you go. And we need to talk to the guys. We need to make sure there's a Halloween one because we need to dress up for that. It needs to be on our own Halloween. Halloween time, definitely. Costumes are planned already for this year. For OTT, need to have the anniversary show again. near Halloween, because I've got my outfit
ready. Anyway, it's always around Halloween, so it's
brilliant.
I was looking at the dates. It's probably going to be the weekend before or the weekend after Halloween. I think Halloween falls in the middle this year, like.
Boot squish. Yeah, hopefully, because I'm just like buzzing. We got dressed up last year, we'll dress up this year again, aren't we?
Oh, yeah.
Unreal. And I need to know if I need a backup then for Hard Knox. So let us
Hard Knox could potentially be the anniversary show, first anniversary show in around that time, though, as well.
That's right, first one was in November, wasn't it?
Yeah, I can't remember the exact date. Was it like the 20th?
I want to say
I don't know. I think I'm just guessing here, like.
Yeah.
It were on a Sunday, wasn't it? So
it was a Sunday.
Carry on watching it and I'll check it out for you. Sunday, 13th of the or the 20th?
12th.
No, that's 19th. Saturday.
No, last year's Hard Knock show was on the 12th. I'm sorry, it was 13th.
Was it 13th?
13th or the 20th, I can't remember.
Lion timer. Down on the neck. Oh, yeah, you're tapping out that all day.
Her back there, boy.
A wild cowboy has appeared in the chat. Good evening, Mr. West.
I hope the wild cowboy who wears a boot. Hola!
CJ West has joined the chat, people.
CJ West came in to say that boots is after stealing his gimmick, I think.
Oh, we need a boots off. We need a boots off. Whoever wins the privilege of wearing the boots, and then if boots loses, he has to change his whole gimmick, and we just call him socks.
Wonder who gets a Cadillac.
I stole the whole damn thing. Cowboy is dead. Long live CJ West.
Are we setting up a feud here for the next Hard Knock show? CJ West against Boots Murphy?
Yeah, I think it needs to be.
LJ didn't like that. Never replicated, CJ. Never.
I've seen another very famous Twitch streamer recently who was doing a cowboy gimmick as well. One of Mr. West's good friends. I don't know how he feels about that.
Like, flattery is a great compliment, like, but then there's just ultimate taking the piss as well and just pure bone-eyed laziness.
I'm working on killing Kane, then I'll move on to boots. I love that. I love that. Have you watched those videos? They're brilliant.
No, I haven't.
Oh, he's doing like big killer moves on Kane. Kane's just getting
Yeah.
Leapfrog was one of them. That popped me massive. Leapfrog. Brilliant. That's why he's getting so annoyed. He's worn down with the fresher man coming
in and taking advantage of the weaker man in this match. Well, it is. Nearly 10 minutes. 9.5 minutes in this match, LJ Cleary so far. Boots only 4.5. Here come the boots. Oh! Jesus, it was a boot, all right, but it was the wrong boot. Both men down. We've got 10 seconds
to go. And here we go. Only one man left.
Scotty's going to come in here now like a fucking fart in a hurry, like he's just going to be gone, isn't he?
Yeah.
Sorry, Lance.
Two men down as well, like you're just like, he's just going to come in and take them off.
Oh man, he's going to be like a scone fresh out the oven now, look, and he's just going to pick the bones, isn't he? Love it.
Again, apologies for anyone who's coming in. I am just muting the music as I don't know what copyright laws are like, so whenever someone's coming in, I'm just muting them. No, sorry, Cowboy, that was me. I don't know what the legalities are for it, like, so. Cowboy said to go for it. He's saying that it's all good, so yeah.
Let's go for it, so.
Yeah, no, just leave them on. That's me. I don't have to play around with this anymore. Suplex, Lyric City. So easy for Scotty Davis. It's just so easy for him. Oh, this is the perfect tactic. German. Giving neither man a moment to breathe. Cowboy literally spent like the majority of last night. I think it was up to like 4 a.m. And then today, getting this sorted. So, I didn't really have enough time to look into what the legalities and stuff were of copyright and stuff.
Beautiful swinging neck breaker. Air, look, let's be grand.
Mark calling it a swinging neck breaker. Get out of that, Mark, do you?
Well, look, I know, say nothing new, but.
It's a fucking gator roll.
Jesus, Boots is gassed. Spinebuster! Massive spinebuster to Scotty. Christ, I take it back, he's not gassed at all. Like that, the fresh Scotty Davis
is down. Whatever energy advantage Scotty may have just been dissipated there with a huge spot.
Everybody said it's grand, it just mutes the part with the copyrighted audio on the VOD, so yeah.
They automatically do it.
We don't see it, it mutes Morphe too often. Oh, I leave my dog back in.
Say it's high risk for a reason.
The Jai's left. Jai's. Oh, yeah.
Where is he?
LJ going up top. He's
going out the back for whatever.
He's going back in his business.
And it's raining, so he's coming back in there nice and wet. My clean floor, how smart.
I did. Leave me alone, I'm only after.
Booth was so good in this match, though.
Yeah, it's probably the best I've seen him. Genuinely.
He was. This is brilliant. Definitely got way over in this match, even though he was over before.
He wasn't, what I liked as well is he wasn't too gimmicky like I've seen him in some other shows. So, like he does his J-ups and stuff, and like he is like doing the boot stuff, but like it worked so well here. Like, and
yeah, it's a fine line there. You need to kind of dance around, isn't there?
Yeah, yeah. Like, and I don't think it's a bad thing depending on the show that you're working on, but like. Sometimes it can be a bit too much, or you could do it too much, and they probably don't even realise it. Like, jeez.
Oh, we love career. I love sleeper wrestling. I think there's a place for everything, but I think he dances that fine line really well.
Yeah, yeah. I love this.
I don't think Scotty liked that.
Dad, no, I don't know what you love. I haven't seen anything.
Claiming the win. Scotty needs to understand this is an elimination match. This is good for Scotty.
That works his favour, but
still, that's still the spotlight.
Did you just pause?
Oh, look at that.
That's exactly what it is. Scotty wanted.
Did you just pause?
Scotty wanted to have.
No.
No? Alright. And I was just LJ stealing Scotty's pain, essentially. And he wasn't happy with it.
To be fair, though, I was not happy with it.
No.
It's last man. Absolutely. Absolutely. But wrestlers are unique people. They want recognition for their hard work and.
I really want to see. Now I know that we got it here, but like I really want to see these guys in a full one-on-one.
Yeah.
The last time they actually had that one-on-one was the stadium. That ladder match.
Yeah.
Saying on commentary at the exact same time. Like, talking over myself.
Just aggressive by Scotty Davis. Kind of getting our old LJ, and we've seen this again. He's gonna go for another one. And there it is.
Beautiful.
And it's hurt.
This is over.
Oh, LJ is out on his feet. LJ may regret taking Scotty's pin. LJ has been in this match.
LJ could sell sand in the desert, like, couldn't he?
Yeah.
Frightening. Scotty, unbelievable.
There's only one fresh man in there. LJ's faced seen off two different opponents already, and now facing the prodigy of Irish wrestling, Scotty Davis. We did say that this would be the biggest test for LJ, clearly, and he does have to take it serious, but. Scotty Davis
digging deep for that, man. LJ first guy in the room, digging deep for that.
I don't know, but LJ clearly went Enziguri to Scotty, and both men out on their feet now.
Just when LJ looked down and out, pulled it out of the bag again.
Guys, the thing is with these two, so
you know what's nice to see if you look around, right? This match is completely holding the audience's attention.
Yeah.
Nobody's on their phones, nobody's looking left or right, nobody's yawning, a bar match. This isn't a piss break. Like, because this match is quite long, you know, but it's not like everybody is focused on what's going on in the ring. Aside from the talent of the ring, I think that's the beauty of Dolan's as well. You don't want to miss it, like.
I think the setup is so good as well that it does. It actually, where the ring is, it just grips everybody into it. Like,
yeah, yeah,
the balcony
yeah.
up around, it's like you just have that. I don't know, maybe the guys feel it more being in there, but like you have that. Like, you're completely surrounded by people. Like.
Yeah. Agreed.
Oh, LJ, lash to days ago pin. Was he showboating again?
Hook the leg, LJ.
Just hook the leg. Put your body pressure through his chest and avoid the man kicking out like that.
I'll take more than that to put Scotty down, though, isn't it? Like, he's still pretty fresh.
You're still seeing that little bit of cockiness that he had in the last couple. I think that's what he was doing there, was a showboating.
LJ clearly right now. Scotty needs to find something to get back into this match.
Look, we'll see, you know. Sometimes sometimes that just adds to it.
Wearing down that
don't you think so? You do. Can't lift you up, buddy.
Missed the first time, hit the second time.
Oh!
Fun Nelson suplex. Beautiful high angle German suplex. Devastating.
Jesus, that was a second. That was a 2.9er. That was by 2.9er.
Incredible combination from Scotty Davis. Scotty laying in the forearms now to LJ Cleary. Scotty had to be told that's a second time. Scotty getting handsy with our referee, Niall Fox. Scotty getting frustrated here. I think that's what it is, Mark. I think he's very, very frustrated.
He's spit in his face. He just spat an LJ.
He's laying in huge shots. And yet to put away European Wrestling's MVP.
Spit to LJ's face. LJ with the roll-up. Oh, and he gets it. He gets it. He stole one.
He gets it with a roll-up. Oh, he totally did. Do you know, I know Scotty let it get the better of him now. He controls the old emotions. I'm sure LJ lives for that, but he just feeds on that, like, so. I know Scotty, you should know better than that.
Yeah, it was disgusting, CJ. It was
the guest being in that spit, no tears, Jesus.
Just that four golden tickets, only two left now, so only LJ and then the winner of Raven against Sam.
Yeah.
So, yeah, near in the end.
I can't be the only one. Who else is living for Sam's social media?
Oh,
I can't believe my heartstrings is pulling on. I don't know whether to give him a hug, cheer for him, make him a cake, or just do all of the above. Do you know what I mean? I am just living through him vicariously at the moment. It's just unbelievable. So happy for him.
If they shout out to the Irish talent who are doing that on social media, like you're
And the main man in our chat as well. Well done, CJ Westlake.
Not reliant on
the pride they're showing.
And the thing is, like, Joe spoke about this in his interview recently as well, saying like that people need to start putting out content. Like, and
yeah,
I think we have the likes of Sam, Boots, and CJ are probably ahead of everybody else at the moment getting their content out there. So
even
everyone else is lacking a little bit. So. I'm not just mentioning you because you're here, CJ. I'm definitely not. But now, genuinely, I think the three boys are probably ahead of the game, from what I can see and what's coming up on my feeds.
They're getting so much more of a rounded view of the business. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Looking for talent as in the ring, right? But, like, which counts for so much.
Yeah.
Even as you were saying, as Joe was saying in his interview with Angus, like, there's just so much more to it. Like, you need to be able to cut the promo. You need to be able to cut up the ring. You need to be able to have audience interaction.
Yeah.
You need to not be able to interact with the audience as well. On the flip side of that, you need to be aware of every facial, every hand movement, every gesture. It's just so much more to it, like, and the work that they're putting into their promos and social media presence, it's just commendable, isn't it?
Yeah, and I think you can see it with Boots and Sam especially, because they're so new to the scene. They're gaining fans and followers through social media.
Yeah.
So that when they get to the shows, like, look at the last OTT show, there was fans there chanting for the Sam, and he wasn't on the show.
Yeah.
You know, they were chanting, "We want Sam, we want Sam," and like, it's phenomenal. Like, and like now here he is booked on the next show. You know, probably because Joe is probably looking at that going, "Shit, like, people want them." Like,
not just booked, but actually on the poster
and on the poster as well. Yeah, it's unreal.
Danny Borden,
King Slayer,
unreal.
Love the jacket.
I want it to, like, go out walking, or I want it, like, the gym, you know what I mean, in the winter. I need it. Now I want Steve's muscle top.
Jay's in the chat.
Would be a boob out each side, so I couldn't. I'd love Steve's muscle top, but, like, I mean, more top would be lost between the girls.
Bring me back to 2020 there, cowboy, with Jay's in the chat.
He's got such a unique look, hasn't he?
Yeah.
No one out there like Danny, like nobody, like Danny Craft.
Such a change from Skater Boy Jay as well that we had just before the pandemic. Like, he's completely overhauled his look, his attitude, his wrestling, everything. Like,
I remember we were in Limerick actually before at a Phoenix show, and Jay Money had a first dates match.
Oh, lads, it was brilliant.
Sitting in the ring at a table just having a date.
Amazing. Fucking brilliant. That could have gone so wrong, but they just done so well, but it was brilliant.
He's so good on the mic here as well. Like.
Yeah.
Magic Mike. What makes you so magic?
Maybe. Steve's pride in Limerick's undeniable, isn't it? I love it. Absolutely love it. Like, he would go to bat for Limerick. Stop Steve Savage from becoming the biggest disappointment in Limerick history. Tell him, Steve. Tell him, or tell him, Denny. Steve, go mad.
Danny Cross really getting into Steve's head here.
Maybe you can magic yourself to 2 months ago and save Steve Savage's OTT run.
Jesus.
I'll tell you what, Mike. I'll make it very easy for you. Magic yourself back to 2 weeks ago before you stepped into a ring for the first time and tell yourself, hey, maybe it's not for me.
Jesus, Danny sounds like me when I'm on a roll in a bad mood, doesn't he? Putting out all the stops like if you're hit the fucking jugular. That didn't happen. Hang on a fucking minute. Yes, it fucking did. Oh, I love it. Oh, sorry.
Laura's in there. She found a picture of J&J Money on her iPad. I'm not sure where you at that Phoenix show in Limerick.
No, I wasn't. But I do remember seeing about that match already.
Danny Cross and Mikey Kelly to start off this match. Danny Cross
might be regretting his words. What a person to learn from Magic Mike, what? Having Steve Savage in your corner. And I've said this before, but like, I think that's a big driving force with Stephen Leon with Hard Knox. You can't help but get swept up in the energy that they have for this business. You can't help it. It's infectious. And whatever they're buying or whatever they're selling, I'm buying all day long and twice on a Sunday. You can't, like, it's unbelievable. You can't help but get invested, like, so they have the right driving force with Leon and Steve. No doubt.
Huge energy. Huge energy in Steve's
house. Huge, massive energy. And that's what he brings.
Maybe that's what Danny wanted.
Has me pumped for the next show already, mate. I'm bringing my fucking energy. A few hours of it.
What's the opinions of the replays in the chat, guys? Do you like them? I think they had a great different dynamic.
Yeah, they do.
So good.
It's something that we don't see on too many other shows.
Yeah. We're seeing it on any show, really. Like, they don't really do that kind of stuff.
Danny Cross knows that Steve can't get involved here. Otherwise, he's costing Mikey Kelly his match.
Hardest part of the ring.
Second.
So, actually, shout out to Fionn for this. Like, he's ridiculous.
Phenomenal work, yeah.
Put everything together, like the sounds and stuff.
Yeah. Bit of inside baseball, but Fionn said that they were going to take a few days off and not kind of look at this after the show. Maybe give it till midweek or the following week before they start working on it. Fionn was working on it the next day.
Right away, yeah.
Yeah, he couldn't leave it. Leon was saying that he was sending stuff over to him. Like, so shout out to Fionn as well for the hard work that he did on this.
So when he puts his game face on at the show, it's unbelievable. It's just like he's just autopilot. He just goes straight in.
He's zoned in. Like, he's so focused.
Yeah, completely, like, totally. Same, Laura, same. Total withdrawals.
We've seen that from Mikey Kelly, but sometimes heart isn't enough, Mark.
Absolutely, but for a guy of his experience, his undeniable courage, his skill set, and his opportunity here in his hometown.
Mikey Kelly's going to learn a lot in this match.
Danny Cross, I think he'll rise.
He certainly is.
Why did you say that? Like you, like fucking Scooby Doo. You knew all along who the killer was. Danny Cross has experience. I saw you in the screen. You were like, he certainly is.
I just said he certainly is.
But stop now, because you know I haven't seen or read anything on this. So can you stop?
Is he giving you spoilers?
I don't know.
I know the man inside out. I can tell by the faces and I can tell by the actions and everything. I swear to God, I know when the man's hiding something. Doing so
puts additional lads, welcome to the domestics of the Rush household. This is what we get before and after we record as well when you watch our podcast. We should leave the camera rolling sometimes.
Yeah, we have to cut out a lot of stuff before.
Yeah.
Stuff doesn't make it to they are on the cutting room floor.
Laura's giving out to you here as well, Jerry. No spoilers.
Oh yeah, no spoilers, Laura. No spoilers at all. Calculated.
You're that mammy again, dying to tell the child what he got for Christmas.
What are you trying to say? Santa knows what they're bringing.
Bit of props here as well for Robbie Mack, our referee for the night. Literally only got the shout the day before. That he was going to be doing a couple of matches, got a crash course off Foxy the night before and on the day, and I think he did two or three matches on the night. One of the good things as well is that, like, he even said to me at the end, he's like, oh, I felt like I did shit, and I goes, you were unnoticeable, you did your job well, you did what you needed to do well, and that's the main thing. Like, you, the focus was on the guys. You were there to do your job, and like there was nothing with like saying, oh, the ref's not doing this, or they're not doing this, or like he was involved enough that he needed to be.
But that speaks to Hard Knox, that he was like, yeah, no bother.
How long do you ref? Do you know?
Robbie? I don't know if he's ref before, to be honest.
Really?
Yeah, nice. he trains wrestling, like he's...
Yeah, I know what we talked about earlier,
Colin. Mikey Kelly's feeling the boy. Hung up on the ropes.
He goes up and over. Oh, and a brutal knee to the head.
Huge knee.
Right to the temple.
Mikey's Danny's dead. He's like a pro dad.
There's a match within the match here. There's a match in the rush house. Don't call these high risk maneuvers for
nothing. Oh, man, I tell you, this is going to be no holes barred. Minute two, you don't cop your fucking selves on.
A match I'll never win.
Very last moment. Don't even bother, so like. It's winding me up, that's what it is. I'm not supposed to be getting off and excited and making the shoes.
Oh, yeah.
I'm not, I said, no, not that condition, sweet Jesus. My recovery, not my recovery. You know, you shouldn't be stressing me. Slightly too excited, waited too long for trying to go
for that big, huge kick. He's going for the... I like that, it's kind of like a crane kick, isn't it, the way that he sets himself up?
Oh,
yeah.
Swinging neck breaker, that could be it.
Purposely didn't call it a gator roll that one. Don't know how Scott would feel about Jay doing that. Yeah, it is a crane kick, yeah.
Won't say no.
Yeah. Guys, sometimes it's best to just stay down. He goes all in on it, like the hands and all go out like, he doesn't just throw the kick, like he goes like all.
Daniel's son,
yeah.
No, man. It's taking a long time. Probably looking for that 450. If he hits this, it's all over, guys.
He's taking a long time up there. He's taking a long
showboat.
His theme.
My. He pays
for it. That was your arse. Mikey's giving away. Oh, and he's back up on
his feet. And that's the experience.
Because his team would that's be was crazy. Well, that I don't know if that's genuinely what it is, and I'm putting makes so much sense.
Totally does. The knees out.
Yeah. Oh, Danny Cross showing target locked in. Referee's gonna have to step in. Mike Kelly will not say. Mike is trying to take
advantage. Danny Cross's leg is done. There we go. Oh. There it is. You're buying, and that's all about this. Don't care.
Behind the back of Robbie Mack. He didn't see it, guys. He can't.
Not called the ref or nothing.
The ref.
Straight into the brain buster. That's it. There's no kicking out of this one.
Oh, he did! Magic Mike.
Well, there's one thing he has in common with Steve Savage, and that's passion.
I don't know how Mikey kicked out of that one there. Pure passion. I honestly don't know how he kicked out. Adrenaline, heart, pride of Limerick. That's how he kicked out, Colin.
Now, Colin, as you told.
Pride of Limerick.
That's the effect. Sometimes. Oh, he's not
finished. Steffi, welcome to the chat. I can hear myself already. We could hear you the whole night.
And Steffi, there's no wrong with that. There's no wrong with it.
Well, you told Sammy D to fuck off, Steffi.
Oh, wait, that's that.
Yeah, do you remember that? The only voice in the room.
Oh!
See, here's Steve. Look, hashtag massive energy, boy. He's just going to clear off after shit out now. Excuse me.
But Steve cost him Mikey the match.
There's
he was already beat, wasn't he? He was already beat.
huge running knee, death on a driver.
Then he had look at that
boy, though.
Steve knew that this match was over.
Steve obviously, like,
he definitely didn't know it was you.
Actually, I'm not really wrestling limerick anymore, so this isn't wrestling. This is,
this is continuity, darling. Unsanctioned. This is unreal. This is just continuity now from the last show and the one before as well.
Oh,
there's layers to this.
Cowboy is built on intensity. I think, like, he eats, like, fucking vaults and watts for breakfast, like, just electricity, energy. It's just a big ball of pent-up energy.
Yeah. Oh, he's bang on. It's so intense. It's brilliant. But everything he does, he's just full on. And I just, as I said, whatever he's selling, I'm absolutely buying. Like, unbelievable.
Steve Savage.
Oh, just saw the luggage. That's the luggage. Off. The logo on his top.
Yeah. Steve's heading back to America soon, isn't he? He's advertised for.
Yeah, he's over there. He's over there in May. Yeah, the next couple of weeks.
But Danny Cross might have backup. Here's Sammy. Here's Sammy on the way out. Steve has the chair.
This, oh, God, I just noticed. I know what this is. This is going to be, there's always a plan B. It's going to be, there's always a plan B. It's going to be Triple H. It's going to be always a plan B. Was there a chair?
It's around Danny Cross's neck.
I'm not looking at the chat. I'm not looking at either of you. Look at this! I told you! I told you! It's a Triple H all with the plan B. What have you done?
Silly boy. Silly boy.
Done. Now look, I can understand why Mikey's up and coming, and obviously, you know, Steve let the emotions get the better of him, especially with who's in the ring with him. But I would not make an enemy of Steve Savage on a good day. But when you hit him with a chair, I wouldn't be making, you know what I mean? I'd be fucking hot-footing it out of Limerick fairly lively.
Not quite the hand that feeds you. That's very fucking silly. Very silly, Mikey.
Is Mikey siding with the draw?
If anything, Steve stopped him from getting hurt even more.
But is Mikey going to side with the draw?
Oh, my God.
Business, it is business, but Jesus.
It's not impersonal, it's business. It's Mikey Corleone, that's what it is.
Could be a good move for Mikey in the long run, though.
Yeah, what, like, if he's... Wait, now, is he going to line it up? Jesus, Limerick doesn't know what to think.
This Limerick crowd has turned on Mikey Kelly, and rightfully so.
You could just stay away, could you? Mikey has turned on them. Why does it always have to be the Steve Savage show?
Steve on the outside asking why.
I will never stand in your shadow. You're awful. What have you done for me? Nothing. A matter of fact, what has Limerick done for me?
Mikey, be careful.
Can you have fire here?
Yeah, I wouldn't be in Limerick same way if you done for me and Conor Mogsarts. Mother of Christ, I'd be baiting down the road to Parky and just out of fear. They'd kill you. In a nice way, though. Nothing wrong with
it. He'll never be allowed back in Pullman Park, you know.
This crowd has done nothing.
Nothing wrong with showing a bit of pride.
Their love, their passion. And this is how he thanks them.
Mikey could regret that.
Mm-hmm. I don't know. Look, come here. I wouldn't make an enemy of Steve, definitely, right? But like, what's Mikey going to learn?
Thing is, as well, like, Steve can't wrestle in Limerick. I'm incredulous. So like,
not a sanction.
Can't have a match. Oh, here we go.
This
one of the biggest matches matches that you'll ever see anywhere in Europe, like, right now.
Sammy's already in the ring. He knows he has a big task ahead of him here. Sammy D, the OTT
saxophone. Every time I hear that's what comes into my head. He's very intense when he comes out as well, isn't he? Like, it's night and day when he's coming out for a match compared to when he's coming out for something else. Like, it's just, that's something that I love to see as well in wrestling that, like, if they're coming out just to have a chat or whatever, like, nice, relaxed, whatever, when it's game time, they're like,
oh, game face,
zoned
yeah.
in, focused, I'm fucking gonna get it, like, you know. And he portrays us so well.
This match wouldn't be out of place anywhere on any promotion.
No.
It's the talents for both these men, and they're still, you know, what age are they? 27, 28, I think. Leighton Buzzard.
Sam's 27, I think. I think Leighton's in around the same.
Yeah. Ridiculously. They're going to be so good in a couple of more years.
Every single person inside that venue believes in this match already because of the impact Sammy had when he first came out and the impact he had in the previous match. And how Leighton Buzzard just presented himself as well.
I think that the crowd,
everybody knows this is a big deal.
Yeah, I think the crowd, it's good that the crowd, it's a real, there's a lot of good wrestling fans there. They all know who Leighton is before he even got there as well. So they know who he is, how big he is, like, and how big this match is.
Yeah, and they already detest Sammy, so, like, you know, the scene is already set. What's wrong with him? I don't know why.
Again, sorry, I'm not sure if I said it on the yoke, but this is the number one contenders match for the Hard Knox Pro Wrestling Heavyweight Championship.
Very, very clever from Sammy D. Very clever. Sammy D is no fool. Sammy knows the matches that Leighton's had this weekend. He was in OTT last night. He saw him. He watched every.
That's you, Steffi.
It's a relentless start from both competitors here now.
Yeah, that's the other thing as well. This was Leighton.
Nothing wrong with it, girl. Nothing wrong with it.
This was Leighton's fifth match of the weekend.
Yeah.
Oh, crazy. That's mental.
Yeah. But you know what? He asked Fight Factory there recently. He gave CBL one of his best ever matches.
Yeah.
Didn't he?
Yeah.
Huge hip toss. It was unbelievable. I just saw a side to CBL. CBL's great, but I just saw a side to him in that match that I was just like, God, he can really, really go. And I said to him at Scrapper, I was like, come here, I just have to say to that match with Leighton Buzzard was...
That's the thing about working with people like this as well. It elevates you. Working with someone that's better than you will always make you better. And, like, you're always learning stuff from them as well. So, like, and it makes you raise your game. Like, CBL's in there with Leighton Buzzard. CBL needs to raise his game in order to be in there with him. And, like, I think I saw 3 or 4 new moves that CBL actually did in that match.
Yeah.
Because he had to, you know.
Yeah. Like, you know, and do you know what? They see sides of themselves and find layers of their skill that, like, untapped, you know, that they've never, ever... I suppose really dug into, you know, or really kind of dipped their toes into, but like they really dig down into the bag and see what's coming out. Like, and but even now, Steffi and Laura saying there that that's their favorite CBL match of the year so far. And I tell you this much, there's just so many huge things coming for him, you know, aside from the award for the best 10, because he gets my unbelievable.
No, I wholeheartedly agree with Laura and Steffi on that one. Like, definitely my favourite match of his of the year so far, yeah. And I think they're only going to get better.
Yeah. And I wouldn't normally approach anybody at a show right now that, because I'm a bit iffy like that, because I thought for days, so I just like don't. But I was just like, I have to tell him that was just crazy. And he was stood like 2 feet away from me, I wouldn't have thought him out, but yeah. Jumpstart this
match. Try to take it. Well, he's changed his whole.
Without describing yourself of not being a psycho.
I think he's changed his whole outlook on wrestling as well. From what I've noticed over the last year, or maybe a bit more. Like, he seems to be training a lot more. He's more character orientated. He's working on himself and his wrestling a lot better. And,
his psychology has changed. Like, you know, as you know, not just the comedy spot that he was doing, you know, a year or 2 years ago. Like, that he can go, like, he proved that he can go with one of the best wrestlers, you know, and the best wrestlers on the planet, and Leighton Buzzard. And
not just that as well, like, his size, you can see his size. Like, if you go back and look at a picture of him maybe 2 or 3 years ago, like, he's after bulking up so much, he's much bigger, especially, like, his upper body, like, you can see he's putting on that weight and stuff, and
carrying fucking bales of hay around the place. So.
I'm saying, And I know people are like, you know, about like blow-ins and people coming in and stuff like that, but there's so much to be learned as well, you know. So, like, talent's only gonna benefit. It's so important to, like, be in the ring with them, to pick their brain, and you'll always learn something.
the seminars that Ireland, the Irish wrestling gets is brilliant as well. All the talent.
Just look at how comfortable Sam is here. Like, I just,
yeah.
I just feel like that old saying, like, slowing down. It's just, it's so clinical. Everything has a meaning and a purpose. And like, even here, like, he's comfortable being uncomfortable, or comfortable doing nothing as well, and measured and taking his time. And oh, it's just the things that, like, it's so hard to, I think, for people to learn that side of things. Again, I'm not one to talk, like, I've never had to do it, but from what I've heard, like, that's supposedly one of the hardest things to do.
Oh yeah.
Like, look how comfortable he is. He's standing in the ring, asking for a mic, and yeah.
That was Mark's hand came across the window.
You're alright, there's nobody like you, Dom. What'd you say, Mark's hen came across the ring?
Mark was on microphone duty for the night. He had to get up run across to the stage.
Gotcha, okay. Gotcha. Oh, I need to bring his own mic because I'm not good for running, so. Just saying. Look at this. I'm sorry now. Look, bow down. Just bow down. Fabulous. I love that. Love that. Like, knowing you're so hated in Limerick, just go all in on it. Just go all in. Why not? What a year for that man. What
again,
a year.
Like, look at how measured he was there. Look.
Leighton fighting back into this one.
And even Leighton is the exact same. Like, they know.
To Leighton.
Like, they know when to turn it up. They're conserving energy. And it's just so good to watch.
Yeah.
So good.
Gates of the Viper, love it. What a nod, like, from the snake, yeah.
The snake to the Viper, yeah.
Damage after damage after damage to the neck of Leighton Buzzard.
Not to Tony D with the chain.
Steffi, I feel like the hate is just me now. Not in Limerick, Steph. Not in Limerick. There's a reason why maybe in the complex, but not in Limerick. There's a lot of other people giving out there as well. The whole way down affects your ability to function, your motor skills, ability to move and use your arms and legs.
The more he focuses on this one area, the less able. Oh my God! Go on with the Rick Rude. Love it. Everything.
He's really picking up. Loving every second of it.
It would have been great with his match with Steve if he came out with a pair of tights with Steve's face on him. That would have just been epic.
Give him ideas.
Omari forever.
Steffi, the biggest Omari fan.
Oh, really?
Really?
Biggest Omari fan, yeah.
What, I need to see Heel Omari now because I didn't see him at this.
What
show.
Is it about Omari that you love so much, Steph?
He's down, he's down with the trumpets.
Not if they all want to, one part of it.
Spend like Therese.
No, but they're all from that era. Right.
They all didn't know that.
Yeah, from Birmingham. That's the Dale quote from Birmingham.
I didn't know he was from there.
I love those drop kicks. And what would you even call it? A front drop kick off the top? Like, it's just so. So emphatic the way he did it. Like, and here's the replay. Like. They just look so much more powerful, those front ones.
And the way he landed, that Tommy D.
Yeah. Unreal.
Doubled so over, like. Come on, man. I think that was a Katie in the back there. Comes back with a turret. And massive Leighton fan, Arcady.
Oh,
huge flying clothesline from Leighton Buzzard.
Like
El Capitan is fired up now. Sammy off his feet.
It was both of them, Katie and Stephen.
Oh, I'm not able. Now Sammy hung up. We've seen this before. Big knee striking coming. And there it is. Lays it into Sammy. Turn the favor for it. Love it.
Super kick to the chin. Leighton going up top.
That's beautiful.
Dance. You've seen that.
Fluid, isn't he? Completely fluid.
I love his transition that he does. I don't know if he actually did it in this match. He hasn't yet, and anyway. But he does a face buster turns around into a big lariat and then the moonsault. But he does the three of them so quickly, like, and they're so fluid looking, the three of them together. It's a great little moveset that he has.
Yeah. So well thought out, like.
Yeah.
Oh, went for the super kick, not happening. Oh, love it. Monster Uranagi.
We've seen Leighton end matches. That was three, with that Foxy. Before. That was three.
You can't believe it. You can't believe that wasn't three. It's going to take more to put away.
Foxy's a dodgy arm for cutting, though, do you know?
Has the elbows well strapped up there?
Number one contendership
for the Hard Knox World title on the line. The carpet burn on the mat.
He's going up for here. Big moonsault. Looks like he's going for that moonsault. One of the best moonsaults in the game. Unbelievable moonsault he has. In the forearms to the back for Sammy D. He's going for that. Steph, I was so close to calling it a rock bottom. Because I think there was a couple of them where he went for them in this. And I nearly called them rock bottoms. It was literally Mark beside me was like, call in there and I guess there. Like, that kind of caught me on. So.
Oh, lovely. Big knee strike.
Sammy's sprawling. Where's he
getting his energy from?
Beautiful.
That is just
so crisp. That's like,
you're just watching someone soar through the air. Yeah.
If you're not hitting a moonsault like that, you're doing something wrong, and you need to keep practicing until you can hit them like that. Because that's so crisp. And look, see how he landed perfect, that he was even out straight into a pin.
Yeah.
So good.
Imagine how many moonsaults were there to get that right.
Oh yeah, hell of a lot of training. Yeah. There's
a reason why both these men are. Anybody know, Steffi? Do you want to know? Did the rock bottom come first, or the Uranagi come first? Did the rock steal the rock bottom from somebody else who had a Uranagi, or where did he get it from?
Oh, Uranagi definitely came first. Has to have been. Around a long time, I'd say.
Like, well, I think it was the standing Uranagi that Solo does. Like, he doesn't go down with him.
Yeah, there was. As far as I know, that's been around a long time. They pick up and just throw him down.
Yeah, yeah. I think it's more common.
You have the different variations, because you have the manhandle slam variation. So you have some variations that go across the neck. You have some that come across underneath the armpit and across the chest or even across the shoulder. So there are slight variations to them as well.
Bookend, that's right. Yeah, Steph, bookend.
Yeah.
Well, that was when Booker was shooting with Rocket. He started stealing his moves instead of the call to bookend.
Oh, great win. Ring awareness there. Great ring awareness.
Not yet, boys.
All right, had his foot on the rope, all right. Had enough energy to get the photo. This match will continue. It's happening.
Lane Buzzer can't believe it. Guys, anywhere else in the ring, that's over. That show's tremendous. That's over.
That didn't have the energy to kick out. Nowhere he was.
Super kick. There we go. And another. Finish it off. Got the third. Beautiful. There you go. Center of the ring. Make sure of it.
Beautiful.
How do you do it, lads? That's how you do it.
Yeah.
And Foxy was safe.
God bless it.
Sammy didn't super kick him.
Foxy's eating more fucking super kicks than burgers, hasn't he? God bless him. Anytime I think of Foxy, I think of his burgers on the
podcast. Love that package pile driver as well. Like, it's good to see someone back using it. Jordan Devlin used to use it a lot. Was finishing in OTT for a long time, so it's such an emphatic move. I think Jordan won the belt with it against Wilder, didn't he?
He did. Shout out to Jordan Devlin and JD McDonough. He's actually been drafted.
Unbelievable.
Massive for him.
Massive when I seen it earlier on.
We need to do another one with some fantasy book when we get the rest of
Like you said earlier today, that Gunther was just drafted draw as well, so we could get...
Triple H actually said a few years ago that he was such a fan of that, and he had watched it. I think it was at one of the NXT things in the UK. Was it one of the NXT UK ones he was asked about it? And he said that he had seen it and he was a big fan of the storyline, big fan of the match, and yeah, maybe at some stage he'll get to run it back.
I'd love, imagine it.
I don't know if WWE would be able to do it justice though.
Oh no, it wouldn't, yeah, wouldn't be the same, like, but it would be nice to see them go at it again. You know, two former OTT champions.
Oh yeah, yeah.
Main event of all,
massive seen it, like.
Yeah. Frustrated at the non-3 count, Sammy takes advantage. Depends what they do with Jordan when he comes up.
Yeah.
This American Psycho gimmick kind of thing he's doing.
Yeah, I like it. I do like it. It's different. Like, it's creepy. It's weird. Yeah. It's, yeah, it's different. Like. Foxy screwed Buzzard. Oh, stop, Francis, will you? Foot was on the rope. Foxy alone. To announce
that you, poor Foxy, can learn from not just the
greatest referee in Ireland, hardest working referee in the world.
In the world. Hashtag Silver Fox.
Steffi. No spoilers in the fucking chat. To be murdered. Liz is gonna kick off again.
Ah, Kenya!
Don't read the comments.
How can you not? You see something moving at the corner of your eye, you're going to look like.
Pay attention to Francis. He's in the chat.
Fuck's sake. It's alright, Steph, I forgive you this time. You're not married to me.
Francis. Are still a bit upset after his last match.
That is rich.
Needlessly interrupting this moment.
Let me tell you something, Foxy. Get the fuck out of
the ring. Oh no, you didn't.
Do not disrespect Foxy. Get the fuck out of my ring now before I take your head off.
Oh, jeez.
Poor referee. Foxy.
Poor Foxy.
Fox is a very respected referee. Francis Mercer should not be speaking.
I'm not gonna lie, Francis, I'm living for your jacket.
No need for that.
Both our disrespect towards our hardest working ref.
Here we go, guys. You're at the ball.
Get out of town, see me. Oh my god, it's like a tattoo. Look at this. It is a ball for Grower County Longford. Here at Dolan's Warehouse. It's the year of the ball. I didn't know he had new music, Steph. I had no idea.
I couldn't tell her nothing. I didn't want to spoil it. Spoiler.
It's so good.
Spoiler, I thought someone else could have, because you know CBL is all for, like, you know,
Country Roads.
Yeah, Longford! West Virginia, I can't sing it. I can't sing anyway, but I would have given it a lash. But I do enjoy shouting Yup Longford at the shows now. Oh, very nice. Turn off the lights, he has to have the tan. I need to see the tan.
Has he used this before? Did he team with...
No, this was his first. This was his first, yeah.
These new get-up. I can't wait to see it, but I'm hoping there's a tan. There's definitely a red arm.
But he has teamed with Kelly Ogislinks before, hasn't he?
Yeah, in OTT, yeah.
The change in the clothes is matching the vibe for Francis. I like that now with the jeans. Now, granted, he just looks like he came out of the farm from lambing. But, you know what I mean? It's brilliant. Look at the tan. Please take off the vest.
Big strong bull.
I'm obsessed. Another debut here in Hard Knocks. And you don't need to tell these people the shoes. Who this man is. The shoes. He's definitely on a night out because they are shoes that a farmer would wear on a night out. Like, no offense, I'm not a farmer, but like, you just know you have the cleanest, shiniest shoes ever.
Oh, there's the respect. There's the respect for the Fox.
Referee.
I can't even deal with it.
They are a pair of brogues, like the big pointy toes.
He's off the coppers after this.
I'm obsessed with the shoes.
Has a goal card.
He's absolutely off the coppers after this, there's no doubt. Like, he's like, I'll go back in the car, I don't mind.
If he was wearing a white vest, it wouldn't work.
Curious position there, Francis. Up and over you go. Whoop. suplex. Beautiful. He coined foxes in.
Silver ones.
Very good.
Vicious lariat. This is over.
Here we go.
Come on, cut.
Here we go, Liz.
Oh my god, he's got another white vest underneath. There it is. I have all this. This is just everything I was missing in my life outside of you.
Oh, well, I got him. No, not wearing a vest.
Lads, CBN looks like a freaking beast.
He's definitely leaned up.
Oh, he looks like a beast. Throws him into the corner.
Telegraph by CBL, throws him up and over. Oh, and he's hung up on the top rope. That's very quick thinking by Francis Mercer.
Quick thinking there, Francis.
Nice neckbreaker. Nice.
Well, certainly not the wind out of CBL. Some patrons here in Limerick, very jealous of CBL.
I can't get over the tan. I'm just obsessed with it. It's amazing.
I can't tan.
But I love his presentation.
Cheer that, Francis. Down and get the El Sunbeds into your pot.
You don't have to wear a vest when you do them.
I'm either white or it's lobster country for me.
Like, yeah. There's a oh. No, he's got a white vest still on him, but there's a different layer of seriousness there to CBL, isn't there?
He pushes him off, gets
wait
him
for
up.
It.
Wow, he's a beast, like.
CBL looking yeah. For
here. Unreal. He is Steffi, yeah, he's upped his game, haven't he?
He is feeling.
That's the beauty of having the different promotions, Steph. That's the beauty of having them. Like, it's you can just see so many different sides and character development left in Unreal.
I shouldn't be biased here.
You'd be biased. He was respectful, disrespectful to Foxy.
On a roll up by Francis Mercer.
There you go. So for anyone in the chat as well, if you haven't subscribed to the Hard Knox YouTube channel, jump over there to Hard Knox and just subscribe to them there, because they can deal with all our support as well.
Get on their Facebook.
They're doing us a massive favour letting us do this watch along. They're obviously giving up a few viewers because obviously yous could be watching over there. So thanks to Steve and Leon for allowing us to do this, but please go over and give them a subscribe there.
You ate that,
but
they're fancy.
Yeah, shoulders, I don't think they were down for three, though.
Oh, don't give him an excuse, Jerry. Don't give him an excuse.
Shoulders were down. I don't know, should you have said it into Foxy when he came out first? I said that the offence might have blinded Foxy
that,
one way.
Would we call that a bro kick from the shoes he's wearing? Is he allowed to call that a bro kick? A pointy toe kick?
Steph, I have to go do a pub quiz now. But now during a certain person's match in this chat, that is all me screaming. Love it, we will absolutely hear for you. Brilliant, good luck with the pub quiz.
The small package, the shoulders weren't down. Foxy was checking. Shoulders weren't down. If they were down, he would have counted.
What a debut by CBL. Francis Mercer may regret messing with Niall Fox.
Steph, come back in the chat if you need any questions answered, if you're cheating, you know.
Enjoy, Steph.
Come, Steph.
Don't do it, Francis.
Suck it in, Francis. Oh, here we go, lads. Here we go.
Here we go. Slam.
The Slam Maguire.
Obsessed.
Slam.
Slam Maguire.
Oh Jesus, the shade in the chat, the shade! I'd give anything if Foxy took off his top in his tan match. I'd give anything, I would. Foxy, I'd tan you, but it's not about her, I would give anything. Could you imagine? It would be amazing. Foxy by hardest working ref in the world. And the fairest.
I'd say props to the new guys as well who aren't wrestling everywhere, like the likes of Francis, Mikey, the likes of Kane and AJ that's coming up as well. Like, they don't seem out of place on these shows. They're getting a nice little run
And like we were talking about this when we were on commentary, this whole show just flowed.
Yeah.
Because there was no intermission, everything just felt like one big long show, like it wasn't like.
But the three shows felt like that.
Yeah, but like it just felt like just so.
I thought this one flew in. Yeah. This one absolutely flew in for me.
Look, what are we, 5 matches in already? Look, it doesn't seem like we're sitting there that long, though.
No. It's
the same. This guy. We're going to absolutely love this match.
Our golden ticket match.
Obsessed.
I love that. Oh, I love the Sam on the screen there. That's brilliant.
Yeah, brilliant. That's brilliant. There's the 5 March.
If we get, I'm gonna have to get that transition off, Fionn, if we get him onto the show or something like.
Yeah, amazing. Seminites.
Semesters. Yes. The guy is at the ringside. Did he show it? I just looked away there for a sec. Did he show them with the mask and stuff? Yeah.
And it's about to get weirder.
Kookiest, craziest. We just call us Friends of Sim. You can hashtag that Friends of Sim.
Certainly out there.
It was a little dance. I call them unique. The
Sim is just here. Do a little dance. How long is he on? I know he's in Ireland only about a year or so, but how long is he?
Oh no, he's in Ireland a few years. Like, he's been living here a while, but he only started wrestling training around the same time as Nathan. I think he was in that beginners group. So again, around September 21 ish. No, cowboy, no.
This way. Put an E after, so put 2 E's after that S.
Jesus Christ.
Cowboy down on dirty. Just
so you know, this show terrible is carry on. Terrible carry on.
I did want some Tato. I was devastated that he didn't show some Tato. Another party
pack. I'll bring you Tato next time.
What goes well with Tato? What a savage the pack of Tato right then. I think fun time's over. Yeah, Cowboy saying there. Sam, Kim, Boots, Josh, all the same intake. September 21.
But it's crazy how comfortable he is in that role.
Yeah.
I think Daryl was the only latecomer in that group. I think he started around October-ish, but I think he joined into that beginners group. Like.
Your cousin Daryl, right?
Yeah. Daryl Trulock, yeah.
Yeah.
I think that was the last beginner's kind of course that Joe did at Skill of Irish Wrestling, I think. I don't think he's done a full course since, like,
okay.
He's had open days and, like, you can go down and train, like, if you want, hit them up. But, yeah, I think that was the last time he actually did a course. It wasn't long after we opened back up. I think we were only open back up in July, I think the first show back was. I think the lads were probably training from maybe, I don't know, May or June maybe. Once the lockdowns and stuff lifted, and then first show had to be around in Belfast then in July. So. A new beginner's course start in June, there you go. Here to here first. Thank you very much, Cowboy.
Nice.
And we have that beginners and advanced weekend as well, taking place 2nd to the 4th.
Yeah.
Of June, in the run up to contenders. Yeah. Buzzing for that.
Gonna be a great weekend. Yeah. Let's see if they're still splitting half of the time the match is over.
Ah, look at him.
Sam's shy. He's embarrassed. Sam is excited to meet Raven Creed. Does he realise he has a match now? Who knows?
Sure, he does.
He's a fan. Sam's a big fan of Raven Creed. And like, it makes so much sense. Oh, he wants a kiss.
Oh, Jesus, you're going to get a kiss, all right.
I think he's more than a fan.
He's giving her the bag.
Oh, cool, that sounds good.
Does he have something in the bag for Raven?
7, Christ.
Mother of Christ, what size is your house?
He's a ranch.
7 sandwiches, Jesus.
He's got a big ranch, the cowboy ranch.
Does Claire know about that?
I'm sure she does.
Oh, I told you'd get a kiss. Yes, no. Playtime's over.
He just wanted to give her some flowers.
Uh-oh.
He just wanted to...
Oh!
Raven! Hard Knox is a... this is a competition for the Golden Ticket Raffle.
His house is tiny, Liz.
She has no time for flowers and fun and games.
Hard Knox. Six bunk beds now and a sleep-up blanket and you're flying. Do mind, because we've had bodies everywhere here.
Top and tail, top and tail.
Friends, he's been lucky.
You've all done it.
All done it. A couple of rear beds on the floor, I'd say.
A couple of blow-up beds.
Come here, we've all slept in worse, Mother of Christ, under curtains and all sorts.
I've slept on a cold kitchen floor.
You slept in a bathtub, love? Only that I woke you up.
I slept standing up in a nightclub once.
Been there.
That was before me, though, wasn't it?
Yeah, a long time ago.
Can't believe some other tramp let you sleep at a nightclub.
Oh, all the lads left me standing up beside a fucking one of those barrels that had a top on it. We just...
perplexed. Yes, was that on the cam?
Yeah.
Go away.
20 years ago.
Jeez, back when we've all fucking dozed off.
Back when I used
there.
To drink vodka.
Yeah, I think we all
never again.
Ended up with some random host party.
Plenty of those.
Can't do that no more.
There's a house party, you know. There's seven people going to be standing. We can all have a party.
There
that
you
time.
Go. There you go.
We're not where the party is, and anyway, yeah.
Don't
bite his fingers.
That's just love, though, isn't it?
He like, I'd say he like a love boy, but maybe not that type of love.
That he is. Yeah.
Dom's on his hand. He's not going to be picking anything out of the bag now. He's doing well if he doesn't have a few broken fingers from that one.
It's the dog snoring. What was that? Dog is fast asleep.
No, he is.
I can hear him. Oh, look, there's his paws.
Trying to get back to the bag again.
Oh! She gives a lovely chop, Raven Creed. A lovely chop.
She's not letting him get to that bag. I don't know if I'd let him get to the bag either. I'd be worried about what's in it. I would Raven Creed continue what she's doing.
I was dying to see what was in
bag.
The bag.
Let him play himself into compromised positions.
He's gone.
What else was in the bag?
Run away now.
Raven's wrecking me head. I'm like, just let him get to the bag, will you?
She's scared him off.
Yeah, like we were on commentary. We couldn't see a fucking thing.
Oh, right,
went
okay.
In the back. We didn't know what was going on.
Raven Creed broke the count. Yeah, listen. Raven Creed's a fighter.
Raven's there he is.
Raven doesn't want to win like that. Raven's not winning by a count out. And the thing is, the one thing that we know about Raven Creed is she loves inflicting punishment on people.
Absolutely.
Raven hasn't inflicted near enough punishment yet.
Raven hasn't found him. She's nowhere to be seen. She went looking for him and he's already in there.
Sam is now back in the ring. Has he outsmarted Raven Creed?
No, here she comes. And again, going back to that bag.
Uh-oh.
Oh, mother of God. The sore shots are the shots you don't see coming.
Aren't sore, are they? I, like, never taken a bump. No plans of ever taking a bump in my life, regardless of what
a
Mark
has. A bump or a chop?
Anything. Nothing.
What's Mark offering?
He just wants to let me bump him at some point. It's like, no, Mark, I'm 42. I'm not fucking getting inside the ropes. I won't even step.
Fucking hard no anyway.
Hard no. No way am I getting...
Hard no.
But I don't even know, like, how sore are those chops? Like, you know, how long does this thing last for?
I'd say, like... I reckon it depends on your tolerance as well, like, and also like the person giving it to you, and then also you have to take into account the adrenaline levels that you're on. Like, the adrenaline could probably numb a lot of it, like, so if your adrenaline is way up, then like you probably don't feel a hell of a lot, like,
encouraging him to go to the bike. She's a big tease.
I'd have to have a word with Mark again.
Picking apart his
hands.
To be fair, it's a rivalry going on here between Liz and Mark.
Oh, we could get well, maybe.
Up,
want to get in the ring and take some bumps with him?
Take a no. I don't.
No, he'll take the bumps.
All like. Oh, right, I was wondering. I was like, I'm going to take no bumps, but I'd kill Mark with words. Love you, Mark. I'm just kidding. We're big fans of Mark here.
He was just, he said, he got on to us there recently. He was drinking with. Can't remember who it was now. I'll find it.
No, what's his name from ICW, wasn't it?
Sunshine Machine, that's who he's with.
Oh.
Drinking with Sunshine Machine.
Barry Ash is vicious.
Which is TK Cooper and... What's the other fella's name?
No idea.
Oh, that's gonna fucking wreck me head.
Brutal clotheslines.
Oh my god.
And on a roll, boy.
Mambo, thank you, Lord. Truck Mambo, that's the one. completely left my head, because the lad who comes over from Belgium, I think it's Nathan O or something is his name.
Yeah.
It's very similar to Choke Mambo, so he kept popping into my head when I was trying to think. I like a serious Sam here as well. It's we saw it at the stadium. He can change it up from being funny to being serious,
and that'll only go from strength
dynamics. Yeah,
he could be a very, very creepy heel as well if he actually went
here. Oh yeah, he gives me fun Karen Noir vibes.
Yeah.
One of the most beautiful entrances I've ever seen, Karen Noir.
Using the referee. Robbie Venus is a weapon there.
Oh, I know that look. I've given that look.
That's a scary look.
Yeah. There it is. He definitely did. This is where you take a few minutes and you're like, do you know what now? I'm going to try and settle this. But I can't because I'm too pissed off.
Don't touch the
ref.
Don't touch the ref. Don't do it, Raven. Don't do it.
What's
stunner for everybody, love it, absolutely love it. And then there's no one to count because you just have a stunner in the ref. Clearly no ref, Raven. You've just stunnered
him in the ring. There's Foxy, look at him back.
Super Fox.
Foxy go by mother of Christ.
He jumped across that stage like a fucking pro.
Like a spring lamb, he was there.
If I had tried that, I'd have just went straight down.
That's like, in fairness, it looks like a short gap. It is not. The ring is actually further away from the stage in this show than it was in other shows. There is actually a fairly decent gap there.
Yeah. No, I would have got a breast in the eye, not a hole. Just say it. I used the word breast as opposed to anything else because I wasn't sure if that would be language on Twitch.
I don't think anybody
might. I think you can say what you want, yeah.
That's all right, cool, because I've apologized 5 or 6 times. But sure, look at us all, it's going to now. Hit me on! Oh my god, get out of this!
Yes! Brilliant. Taste of her own medicine.
Oh. That was everything. So right up there with CBS.
Again, this is, there's a golden ticket on the line here.
Oh yeah. What's going on here? Can Sam take advantage?
Oh, right in the Jesus Christ. Vicious elbow to the chin
of the Sam. Oh, he doesn't know where. What did she call him?
Foxy. Sure.
There.
She pointed at him. She says, "You prick, or you bitch, or something like that." I can't remember what she said to him.
Oh, I think she's used prick a lot. Are we going to see
what's in the bag
eventually?
What does he have? What's in the bag? We're about to find out.
Raven, what's in the bag? What is it? What is it? Oh my! It's a super soaker. Oh my God! It's a super soaker.
Fired her straight at us.
Oh, not like this!
That definitely wasn't water.
Oh, don't now. Please tell me it was still a clear liquid. And that was that. Oh, I enjoyed that. Raven Creed's like, what the fuck just happened there? What's going on? I won, but I'm not really sure what happened.
And like, this is for someone who's tapped and crazy. She's even going, what the fuck was that?
Yeah. The only thing
missing was fucking Nurse Cratchit, like, it's definitely fucking one shoulder.
Look at her face, she's like, what the fuck?
But you know what? As a once-off, they would make just the most beautiful tag team.
Yeah.
If the circumstances required it, don't you think?
Yeah. So there we go. Raven Creed, LJ Cleary, our two final ticket holders.
That should be good.
It can be only one.
It can be only one.
Are we gonna see a match? Is that Cleary back in his shorts?
Mm.
For anyone who doesn't know, this man just lives in shorts. Like, it could be minus 10 outside, he's wearing shorts.
He's that man in the meme with the hoodie and the shorts walking in the snow.
In the snow.
I love that she has it in her mouth.
I just got some information from Hard Knox Management that I wanted to come out and inform you about myself.
LJ showing off his four golden tickets.
July 30th, back here in Dolan's Warehouse, Hard Knox presents Hard Look. Right now, you have what I want. And I know I have what you want. So July 30th, it's LJ Cleary versus Raven Creed. Golden tickets, winner take all.
Lads, who do you want to see face Terry Thatcher?
July 30th, we're gonna know who our next number one contender is. July 30th, Hard Luck, and it's gonna be Hard Luck.
Oh, right, okay, we need something casino themed, so do we? I'm gonna have to wear red.
Has this stuff actually come into your head?
Oh yeah, everything like that.
Stop.
That, boom, boom.
What's that?
Your ideas for casino themed?
Oh, you've no idea. I've already also picked out in my head. It frightens me, Colin. You've no idea. I swear, my mind does not stop.
And a week later is your birthday party for her.
Birthday. Which is also casino themed.
Casino themed birthday
and
party.
It's already. I've got the boxes ticked, mate. Outfit for. Enter name here for the OTT anniversary show Halloween outfit already chosen.
Fucking hell.
Axel Brady, listen to this, man. July 30th, Hard Luck. Tag title tournament. We're in it. We're going to win it, man. See that in tag titles. We got that easy.
Party is it July, Laura?
Does not concern you.
Tag tournament, I am. What about this, right? You bring Max or I'll bring Fabio. June 30th, bam, 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 I'm gonna smash the head off both of you, you little pigs.
Don't be talking to me like that, you little ignorant fool.
Fake, are you, little fool?
Don't be annoying.
Hang on.
Wait a minute, lads,
Kicky ball, what are you?
Are you talking about a tag tournament?
We are.
Oh, okay. We forgot about the Playboys. You saw us go to war with the Kings.
Yeah,
now we're gonna win that tournament. The man who you bring. Knock your teeth out.
Me and Fire are gonna slap the head off you, fucking fix that hurt, we'll slap the head off you too.
The boss out of Martin.
Are you sure?
Don't be annoying me. Living for us. Living for us.
This.
Oh, look at it, here we go!
Cowboys rooting for Martin.
Speaking of names, what do you have? Galaccini and his best friend.
Everyone rooting for Martin.
Doing on the next will we see a CJ no. West in the tag team tournament, no. I wonder?
And Martina,
oh,
maybe?
Not on the show.
Or maybe Boots Murphy.
So many chances and you let me down every time. All I'm saying is, if I'm not on the next show...
It's a singles guy.
Look at this, look. Right, come here. Bet you in a little secret. I used to work as a holiday rep, right? And I swear to Jesus, Easy Peasy Galaccini is the person we all knew was going to step off the plane. By that picture of him there in the shirt drinking the giant tankard of beer, he is the person that we saw getting off the plane knowing that he was heading straight to 18 to 30s without, and went, and you know, ever see this thing that says like narrator, Larry, so you know, friend, let's go and drink until we have to go to our flight to the airport. Yeah. Such a good idea. This was not a good idea. He's the friend. He's absolutely the friend. He's 18 to 30 written all over him.
I love this. Who's your man?
Random people. Like.
It's all my God.
Brilliant. Look, there he is again.
Yeah. He absolutely took part in wet t-shirt competitions, the whole shebang, you know it. Pub crawls, everything.
Kitchen, that's the one. Kitchen. I forgot his name. I couldn't remember his name.
This is amazing.
Phone. Alejandro, Chris Kirby, operations manager. Hey, where are you in Galaccini? Spain.
No idea who he was.
I'm after booking a match for you two fucking clowns and you're in Spain. Look, do whatever you have to do, okay? Get yourselves down to Dolan's Warehouse this Sunday, April 16th, and if you're not there, if the pair of you aren't there, you can forget about Hard Knox. Do you understand me? Am I making myself clear?
Yes. Okay,
Ian's in a Bojangle. Oh my god, it's even like the hotel rooms on the beds are literally like fucking bunks on a ship.
Poor Alejandro. Having to get this Egypt back to Ireland.
I wish he woke up with a tattoo here somewhere, or like love and half of these knuckles, and he's missing a finger. Do you know what I mean? Something that would have been amazing.
Guys, Galaccini and Alejandro were over in Barcelona. Did they get back?
I hope they make
like,
it.
So the thing is, right, Galaccini isn't going to remember any of that. Alejandro has to deal with all the shit.
He's dealing with the fallout.
Oh, imagine getting that Egypt through the airport. Getting him onto the plane. Oh, nightmare.
But then you get through security and he's sat in there waiting on the flight and he comes to life again. A pipe and he's brand new. Yeah, he is the guy. He is the 80s turkey. You know.
But I have it on good authority from the referee that they are here in the building and they are ready to go. So let's make some noise for Axel.
Axel, who's Axel?
Who's Axel?
Alejandro. Why did he call him Axel?
Easier to say.
This girl again mixed up here.
Somebody's here.
Is this gonna be like
music playing?
The Hangover?
They're not here. Guys, they're not here. They're in Barcelona.
That medic behind us, by the way, was having the crack. She loved it. She absolutely loved the show.
This is brilliant.
Oh, he's got a come out now and he's literally going to be hanging out of his anus, isn't he?
Nobody's here. All Chris Kirby can do is set the match.
If Axel legitimate Galaccini want to keep their jobs, they'll get to the ring right fucking now.
They're not here. How can he make these stipulations? They're not here. Listen, if they're here, they're here. If they're not, they're not. Chris Kirby, he said that he's going to fire them if they're... Yes!
Oh, Alejandro's here.
And Axel's here!
He looks a bit fresh. He's definitely fresh. And Galaccini?
Axel looks in good form.
Oh, look! Mother of Jesus, look at the cock.
It's like weekend attorney.
He's definitely have to get one of those drips. You know, you get them like when you're in Vegas, yeah. You're on all like vendors and you hook up to these drips and
the
these
IV, yeah. Yeah.
That's it. And just like be revived. He's definitely had one or two of them.
No. No would be my answer.
Alejandro's gonna be very busy.
Oh, I'd be hiding the gawks and everything. No.
You need about 700 pick me ups. Does anyone have a bloody Mary for Galaccini? Maybe it's just food poisoning. Maybe it's jet lag. Don't assume the worst. Food poisoning. I always think it's food poisoning.
I love that he's still in his shorts. Seems like the first night.
Sandals and white socks.
Yeah, there you go. There you go.
Sliders and white socks, yeah. He should have been kicked out just for that.
I know, I was like,
oh. I would have loved to have been his rep because the commission I would have made off him, he would have been on every bar crawl I'd been into.
What's in the suitcase?
He doesn't even know where he is. He only appears to have one shoe, that's alarming.
I would like to issue an
apology. He only has one shoe on.
We've all been there.
On behalf of Hard Knox.
I forgot how good this was. Putting his shoes on. Oh, forgot all about that.
This isn't too professional.
No.
Well, what was Chris Kirby expecting?
I want you to know, and I want you to know, if you lose this match, you're done. You're fired. No.
Oh, man, don't fold it in now. You got to win this match.
Cowboy was sitting there going, lovely. This is going to be a walk. Absolute walk.
Oh, he looks like he's going to heave. He can't because I heave. If he does, I'm done. I can't.
Here come their opponents.
Two people who can hack the session.
Session has hit Limerick.
It's a before and after session. This is what happens before the night starts.
Boys, if this is actually a session, as does be with the session mark.
That's old school Martina. Sounds tough.
He's out of his depth. Way out of his depth.
I don't remember this match at
all. What a session.
Oh, Oh my
god. Those hips don't lie.
There's a bit of deep pelvic action going on there, right? Mother of God.
How could you wear that white? If I wore white, there would definitely
be brown on it.
Well, there's not room for error in them. There's no room for error in them pants.
Definitely passes the Daz doorstep challenge, didn't we?
My God. They're whiter than Ross's teeth and friends.
And there is strobe lighting.
I love it though, the fact that it's a matching ensemble is amazing. Standing next to Martina, you look like CBL's 10.
The fans won't be back for valid reasons. The whole atmosphere just changes in the room when Martina comes out, doesn't it? It's
actually breakfast.
Yeah, you can just feel the room just picks up. People just get excited and ridiculous.
White attack as opposed to pink and black attack from Bret Hart there.
Looking like the hangover's kicking in. Oh my god.
He's back in the club.
He's at that half drunk stage, do you know what I mean? When you're starting to sober up but you're still merry.
Last song of the night in the nightclub at 8 o'clock in the morning, and somebody's fucked and somebody's just still buzzing.
They're feeling it.
What a move! I'm CJ West for another move. I'm feeling it. Oh yeah, I've just seen your pink t-shirt now.
And the hairband.
Go where I can, quick. Revolver. There you go.
Poor Gattaccini's two sashes of revive sharp have been alive.
CJ West looks really animated. CJ West, the king of the axe handle.
Gattaccini thinks he's pulled.
He's moving like that, he'll pull a muscle.
This Dowlands crowd loves the sesh.
I hope Gallicini's ready for a session.
He certainly looks like he's revived a bit. Gallicini wants the session with the session.
Martina's facials are always amazing, aren't they?
Yeah, brilliant.
Oh dear Jesus.
Give him a cure.
He needs the cure.
He needs him.
He definitely needs the cure.
Probably needs a lot of cures.
He's looking a bit fresher than he did 5 minutes ago.
Session might do that to you.
Another can of Heineken. Popeye has spinach. Session might has cans.
Popeye spinach.
Alejandro taking the bag away so that you can't go for too many more.
No.
Oh no, that was a bad idea.
He wasn't ready.
Oh, lad, he's,
poor
Gallicini.
He's
not going
to
be sick, is he?
Off
he does,
I'm done.
He's not going to be sick,
is he?
He's ready to call Ralph. You're not a real hot man. You don't even drink. You're an idiot. What, this is such a bad decision. Don't spin him.
Gallicini is defenseless. This will do nothing for
his hangover.
Oh no.
That is...
I feel sick just watching it.
Somebody got a bucket. Can we get a bucket out here?
Needs a bucket. I love this match so much.
Both are down.
Oh God, help us.
Session and a load of spinning will do that to
you. He couldn't tag a Christmas present.
Here comes Axel.
Okay, normality now.
There we go.
See
DJ West showing off the drip here.
Full two. Brave man.
Mm-hmm.
Brave man.
I was wearing something like that, the brave pants would have definitely split up the arse by now. Your fourth pair. My fourth pair.
The drip, did you like that one? Seth Rollins-esque.
But you know what? It looks fab.
Looks deadly. I'd hate to wrestle in it.
Oh, many percent, but like...
It's like he was sweating buckets. That room was warm. That was a warm room as it was. And then the lights as well. And, oh, can only imagine.
The last you need in that suit is a drip.
I hope there's plenty of baby powder in there.
He's so warm. CJ West looks fresh in
that suit. Kind of looks like a...
Doiling and profiling.
He looks like he should be on Miami.
Yeah, I the styling of it is immense. If
I see. We can't disclose his location.
I'm sure he has a
lot of arm drags of his own from CJ West.
I'm sure there's a pink Cadillac outside somewhere.
Push it to the limit on repeat.
I need a camera shot of Gallicini.
Gallicini's dead. He's asleep. He's actually asleep on the ring apron.
Baby, he's just having a break.
He's out there.
He's lying down on the apron. Leg drop. Having a nap.
It's kind of like a handicap match because I don't think Gallicini's going to do much help.
Gallicini appears to be here in body, but not quite in spirit.
Oh, he's here in spirit, all right. Just we don't know which one.
Gone from the game.
If you take the 80s, ball it up, put it into a person, that's CJ West.
I'm from the 90s.
Oh, the double elbow would drop to Alejandro. One, two. Sessimo Martina calling for the finish. Not quite. Needs to do a bit more than that to keep the fresh Alejandro down.
Alejandro and Gallicini's jobs are on
100%. Martina traffics drugs into Miami to CJ West. There's no doubt, like, you can see it. You know what I mean? Definitely pays for the one play.
Two people now.
Cannot confirm or deny that.
I don't think he cares at this stage.
We can't tolerate, we can't promote drug trafficking.
Can't say, can't say it was Miami either. Location undisclosed.
Sick drinking game. Sick drinking game.
Well, I like this pairing.
I love that. Yeah. Sip, chop.
Oh, an forearm uppercut to the jaw of Alejandro. Swinging back kick.
Jeez,
she's calling from this crowd.
Sesh breaker.
Oh, I think she was going for that cold breaker.
A cold breaker.
I don't know how she moves, but after all of the...
I'd like to say he needs a tag, but I'm not sure what he's going to do when he tags in.
Like, Jesus, I have a tough time after a big dinner now.
The jacket's after coming off. The jacket came off.
Oh, mean in business, bye.
never consumed them in my life either.
No. No.
Everyone in that building consumed them that night.
And a tag to Gallicini.
Wrestling is our drug of choice.
Supposedly fresh men.
Nice clothes, man.
Yeah.
Big devastating clothesline.
Ah, there's this hand.
Say hello to what?
I'm feeling Gallicini's gonna have some scars on his face after this one.
Here's the axe handle.
You could have pinned Gallicini there and counted to 12.
King of the axe handle, and he's gone up top. And there's another one. He's not the king of the axe handle for nothing.
What's in this bag?
CJ West channeling as Tony Montana.
What? What's in the bag? This is...
What's in this bag? I think...
Oh my God! That's why you said nothing!
Bag. That's a bag of Columbia's finest.
God.
Flower bomb!
Liz is loving this.
I haven't seen it, so I could see. You know what I was thinking of? Do you remember the two guys from Ireland who were caught at the airport with the top knot?
Yeah.
Right? That's what I say. Like, that's what they're like, you know, that they met in a club and she was like, yeah, I was smuggling the drugs for you. And...
Gallicini back up and alive now after that.
Whatever was in that bag helped him, you know, cured the hangover.
Oh, come here, look at this now. He's ready for round two now.
Gallicini is back! massive bump by Gallagini.
Oh! Look, his eyeball drops. Nice.
And that's it. That's it.
Oh, and a kick
out by Gallagini. Just flying up off the mat.
I thought that was it all over.
I could have booked this. Can you know that? Maneuver before,
but whatever was in that bag is after giving Gallagini some sort of bumping power.
Bumping power.
Uh-oh. Canvas ruined, yeah, absolutely.
Oh, no,
I think the lads are trying to sweep it for about 10 minutes after the match.
Gallagini got out of the way.
He's so Hoover's what you need there. You need Henry in there.
Oh, and a big axe handle.
Two extremely energetic individuals in the ring now.
Springboard axe handle.
Curiously so. Both guys up to their eyeballs on whatever was in that bag.
Crowd got behind Joel here as well, Cowboy.
CJ West coming like a train.
Went for that rough rider.
Oh!
Big beautiful. John Wu into the corner. CJ West is down. Gallagini is up. Up to his tits in whatever was in that bag.
That man will not sleep for a week. Oh, here we go. Here we go. He's not dizzy anymore. Oh, he splashed him.
Oh, big spear.
Oh! Love this.
And they saved their jobs.
You can afford his next holiday now, what?
You can afford
straight booking. Online booking.
That's to me. See, this is my bullshit in the chat by CJ West. This kind of stuff, I love comedy wrestling, and it's so good when it's done right.
Yeah.
And this was done right. I love this.
And the session is back on.
I don't know if the session was feeling the session.
I think Gallagini.
Oh, I can't. I can just see it on the fucking And everyone's avoiding him like the plague, and he's just grinding up on everyone. I can just see him, but we still take money.
Gallagini's back in Barcelona.
He's that boy that strips, that used to strip. Every weekend.
Oh, by the end of the night, he is in there,
yeah.
Pants around the ankles doing a helicopter. Like 100% he is.
Ever since the whole month.
You alright here, Cowboy? you tell me what was wrong with him. I don't know if he wants to say. Gets a can. No, don't want that.
Don't do it.
I'll just say he's in absolute pain. He's in absolute agony.
I'm in pain. Oh my god!
Yeah, there it is.
Love that. Still managed to get the worm in. What a boy.
What an outing from these four.
Just dying to get out of the ring and get to the back. Dying to get out of the ring.
I said you can see.
Hello, go back and watch and we'll be able to see it. I was looking for I forgot to look for it. I said that I was gonna look for it, but I'll have to go back and have a look. The worm was a very bad move.
Oh Jesus Christ, did you smack your knob off the canvas? Oh no way. I love this is like the end of a really great wedding, isn't it?
Yeah.
We can no longer confirm or deny what was in that bag. We recommend not trying to use them kind of bags to save your
job. What?
Oh, you got a nice nutcracker.
Oh, I bet.
I'll have to go back after this and try find it again. See if I can see it.
They're not coming down for a week.
Oh, we see it here actually.
Sweep it up, boys.
Poor Ken.
Very small brush.
The worst brush. I think they ended up getting a bigger one now.
An old Dyson, I would have thought.
Like a comb or something. It's very small. They need a big brush. Industrial size brush.
haven't seen this yet.
No. Are you in it? I'm only human. I'm only human. Don't put the blame on me. I'm only human after all. You're shocked, Chris, now you're human after all. Don't put the blame on me. Don't put the blame on me.
Why don't you ask Terry why Butch put him through a table? What you said to me in the ring after I came out and saved your skin, by the way. Oh, no jokes. This isn't a joke. You gotta take this seriously.
All I said to you was, don't treat this like a joke.
Don't treat this like a fucking joke. I thought you had enough respect for me not to put me in that fucking rabbit hole. I know this clown right here, he doesn't care every time I walk out to anyone.
Not a clown.
Oh, Butch Armstrong's nothing but a joke.
What the hell is this? A wet towel.
Butch being Butch.
This isn't a shower, guys. This isn't changing after a match. Let's get serious. Let's get the talent showcased in the ring and less of this gimmicky shit.
Oh,
you,
Liz.
You've had my back. If you turn around and say that,
zero fucks
like that,
given.
And you wonder why. Terry, this isn't Butch walking in the cell. This isn't happy-go-lucky Butch slapping everybody's hands. I'm not fighting for anybody else anymore. I'm fighting for me.
That's fucking good. That's why I said what I said to you in the ring. You come out there, right. You're all singing, all dancing, Butch Armstrong. It's going to be a real fucking short night for you. I'm going to give you your big fucking payday. I'm going to give you your main event spot. And not just any old match. No, bollocks to that.
Tell your cousin they subscribe to the Hard Knocks YouTube channel.
You
what,
you bring
then she can ring you while you're both watching.
Well, April 16th, street fight. Hard Knocks Undisputed. You're going to find out that no matter how good you are not good enough to.
Oh, Terry. May the best man win, yeah?
Yeah. Well,
we're
going to
stick
forehand.
Oh.
That's scary.
Oh, I believe it.
Mm-hmm.
Come here, I'm not going to say nothing there, right? But I'd like to think I had a hand in Butch getting this match. I'm just saying, right? You want happy.
I think you should have been getting the shit that I was getting off. You're the one who crucified him, not me.
I've taken a leaf out of LJ's book there. It's like, I go, ooh, yeah, I said it, and I'm off. But I'm just saying, you're welcome. Oh, keep her on side, Solar. Are you getting a hairdresser voucher?
She's,
keep her on side.
She's your favourite cousin, I hope.
Guys, what a massive main event that we have here tonight. Limerick Street Fight.
Cool entrance for both, actually.
The last show. This got personal very quickly.
Extremely.
Look at this wrestling screen.
Mm-hmm.
Amazing. Love.
We saw what Butch did to Terry. We're not really sure what's going to happen tonight because it's a Liberty City street fight and it's...
Anything can happen. I just hope, Jerry, I just hope that someone isn't seriously hurt tonight.
Well, we can see a medical personnel on scene tonight, so we're hope they're ready for what comes after this match.
Oh, for good.
I know, but I want to watch this too. I'm not bothered.
I can feel the tension has risen in Dolan's.
The silence is deafening right now. People are
the tension has
seriously
risen.
Worried about what's going to happen.
Yeah. I think we have as well. I think there's definitely an air
gone.
Worry in the air about.
He's trying to get a drink there.
Oh, this is the start of this match.
No, must be watching us from there. Fridge is just there. Making sure no water gets on all the fucking plug we have fucking looked around here.
That would be about right now to blow the whole gap up on him.
It's after such a big match as well. Before that, like such a fun match, like
yeah.
the whole atmosphere in the room was shifting.
Yeah.
At this point, like it's
And Callum, was your interview with the boys shown on the screen prior to the match?
I actually can't remember what was shown on the screen, to be honest. I don't think it was. That video was different. I think he did show something, but it wasn't that.
It's the table spot, but I don't think that anything else.
Yeah, I think it might have just, yeah. It definitely wasn't that video though. I think Leon was just had so much to do. I don't think he actually got it ready in time. Yeah. It was such a hectic couple of weeks from so. Tension in the room had risen. The atmosphere was just so different. You can feel the tension in the room, like it was unreal.
So many of them as well would have been present at the last one, though. So
yeah, yeah.
They knew what were coming, like. See where he's from in Clondalkin. My aunt lives in Clondalkin. Or is he fighting out of Clondalkin or living there?
He's fighting out of Temple Bar, boy. Why have Clondalkin?
But he's in the zone here now.
Love. Obsessed. I am loving this. Can't take my eyes off it.
Just added to the whole presentation of it. Like.
I swear to God, hello, high water, you wheel me to this next show.
And all these boys come up and they block the hard camera. What a fucking start of a match.
I honestly thought that, like, you know, it wasn't the person carrying the belt. He was going to be one of the other hooded guys and not the first person to throw him off. But oh my God, imagine coming in like that. Unbelievable. Love.
Holy shit. Terry Catcher came off the top of the balcony.
That's why I'm in shock here. Like, oh, that's genuine. Like, that is a genuine reaction.
Unbelievable.
Lads, I didn't know. I was like, what the fuck are they pointing at? And I looked up and he's like
midair.
Mid, like at the peak of his jump. And I'm like, oh my God.
Amazing.
Unreal. Unfucking believable.
Oh, you're right, Laura. What a banger. Unbelievable.
Terry Thatcher has revenge on his mind here tonight, guys.
He just set the tone for the match so well.
Oh, you just knew then. You're buzzing now to watch this, aren't you?
It's crazy, like, when you watch the whole match, it's fucking ridiculous.
That change in attitude and focus from Butch on display.
It's almost a diehard Bruce Willis look as well for Terry, isn't it?
Yeah. A street fight. You have to wear the jeans in a street fight.
I know, yeah, definitely, but it's just, it gives that vibe, like, it totally gives that vibe in the best possible way.
Hopefully, most people didn't see who was there. I think he got himself out of the way fairly swiftly. Look at this again, like, fucking hell.
Like, imagine being where the and see just out of the corner of your eye.
So,
like,
Liz, he didn't jump from the, do you know the little ledge that's up there?
Yeah.
So he wasn't on the ledge. He was actually on the railing, yeah. So he was actually higher, like, it was unreal. Like, that's when I looked up, like, he was mid-air after jumping from the railing.
It would have been too
so high. Like.
But you know what? As well, because of his size and height, he'll get away with it. If you were any bit taller, there you were hitting the roof. Yeah.
Like for anyone who doesn't know, just at the corner post there, there's a little railing. I think Steve jumped off it.
There is a little step up,
it's just up there on the left there, just by the.
Did Thatcher jump off it the last time? Actually, did he hit the elbow off it?
Swanton off it.
Steve did the swanton off it. Yeah, but so like. Think people might actually think that it was from that ledge, but it wasn't. It was actually the railing at the actual balcony, so he's another like 3 or 4 feet up there, and then jumping from it up as well. So geez, he must have been, I don't know, 15 foot in the air easy.
Yeah, easily. Yeah,
guys, if you've never felt a kendo stick before, it bends around your body. The noise wraps around.
Felt a kendo stick before the start of the show. Even the slight, a little tip of one, like, it just, you can feel it, like,
it stinks.
We had a teacher in primary school who used to use bamboo sticks to whip your hands if you were ever bald. Those things hurt like a
fist. Like, trying to stab him into the head with it, like.
No, Butch, no! That's too far. It's too far, Butch, no! Rex will beat up the teacher.
He was trying to stab Perry Thatcher into the head. Both these guys, there's a safety concern from both of these guys in a match like this. Someone could get seriously, seriously injured here.
I don't think Butch cares at this stage. He wants that title. He'll do anything to have it. It's a street fight. Anything is legal.
It's so different to watching a street fight on TV to actually being in person. Like these types of matches actually scare me.
You just don't know what to expect. And like when it starts like that, you're like.
I think when you see it on the likes of WWE, AEW, like I think you're a bit numb and accustomed to it. But when you see the stuff in person, you're like, oh my god, this is like really dangerous. PTSD hairless.
Don't do it again. Dear Jesus.
No, Butch, no.
Don't do it.
Terry fights a super kick. And Butch goes off the stage.
Terry needs a better rest
fight back here.
Terry regroup now.
It's hot. Terry looks like we're gonna get a repeat of the last show when Butch put Terry.
Oh, he hit him with a chair!
Diving headfirst into a chair!
Into the chair! Through the chair!
The camera angle didn't even catch that properly, like, it smashed him in the face.
Terry's out!
He's not getting up! Giving another angle.
Terry's out!
He is not getting up! Butch has it! This... All he has to do is pin him! Terry is out!
He's an angry little elf.
Like I just said earlier on, Liz, like it's not the loudest room, but everyone is engrossed in the
Everyone's
match.
Invested,
you know,
yeah.
Like it's not a case that people aren't looking at it or they're bored with it or anything. It's they're just like they're honed in on it, like.
Yeah, no, there's just a high level of engagement.
You see everyone up around the balcony. Everyone is looking over. Everyone's.
They're all leaning in. Yeah. Everyone's like fully immersed, like, you're right.
I think the minute he jumped off that railing, like, it sucked everybody into the match.
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah. Nice. That was a two.
Guys, this is difficult to watch.
Ian standing at the side of the ring there, he says, we had to go up and move. At the start of the match, so he says, I just stood for the rest of it because I knew that they'd be out and all over. So everyone who was in that front section, look at all the chairs are empty. Everyone's standing at the back because they had to move so much. Like.
Whatever it takes to put Terry Thatcher away, he wants that title.
Another chair. One evidently wasn't enough. This isn't easy viewing, folks.
This is going to get ugly.
This is uncomfortable. No, Butch, no. Again. No, don't Butch,
this
no.
Is over. If it's over, it's
no,
over.
No.
Oh!
Thank God.
Terry saved himself.
Thankfully.
Terry might have just saved his title.
Thankfully.
Oh!
And he hits it.
Did he hit it?
Did he get all of it? He caught all of it, but Butch came down onto that chair. Thatcher's spent though.
He's spent.
He has no energy to get the cover. How much more could either man have left of this?
And again, like, what are we 5 minutes into this match, if even, like, and
yeah, it feels like it's been an hour when you're looking at
the story that they're after telling so far in the match, and the stuff that they're after doing is, it's just, yeah.
Both men with a chair.
This is how it's done.
Both have chairs.
But you can feel like the fingers, you know what I mean? When it's back up your hand.
When they were doing it, I was like, this is really.
Laying into Butch, and Butch coming back, chops to Terry Thatcher. Neither man willing to give an inch.
Returns the chops.
It's vicious, vicious fight. Oh, and Thatcher coming back and getting a better of Butch. And swing it back in.
Thatcher rolling.
Love it.
Beautiful step up in Zaguri. Butch hung up on
and
the ropes.
Shows the different gears that he has. Like, he's able to just turn it up when he needs to.
This is beautiful.
Between both sets of ropes.
Oh, drop kick to the back.
A big drop kick to the back. We've seen that before by Thatcher, but I don't think that emphatic.
Oh. He's really a home in a street fight, Terry, isn't he?
Yeah.
Shows, like,
he loves the aggressive types of matches. They definitely bring the best out of him. When was the last time you saw a lion salt?
Yeah.
Oh, the kick out by Butch. Kick out at two by Butch. Guys, I just want this one to be over.
Beautiful lion salt.
Yeah. I'm obsessed with the graphics leading into the replay.
Yeah.
It's Terry's turn with the kendo stick. What can he do with it?
What he did to him.
Butch is out.
He's just battering him.
Shattering the kendo stick. Nothing left of it.
Nah. Just meh.
Just throws it into the face of Butch. This is extreme violence.
This is Hard Knocks.
Hard Knocks hits different better.
The noise of it.
I love it. You just, you're like, you know what? Just fuck the chair at him. That's like when your gun runs out of bullets, you just throw the fucking gun as well. You're like, that's how much I fucking hate you. Have that fucking gun at all.
Butch Armstrong definitely not giving up easy here.
Butch so good in this match as well. Like, I haven't seen Butch like this before, like this good.
He's showing how much it's meant. Neither man willing to give an inch for the distinction of being Hard Knox Pro Wrestling World Champion. At St. Mark, there's a world championship at stake here.
I think that's something that we kind of forgot during the match as well. It was a world championship match.
Didn't even need a title. You know what I mean? That's how good it is. You could have got this match, could have been a non-title match, and it would have still banged, like, by the looks of it.
I love that spot there because it looked like he was going head first and didn't. It looked
the
like
chair
he
dropped and he pivoted.
That always makes me feel sick when I see that.
Oh, great transition into the German.
Yeah.
Look at that.
Monster Stan Hansen Lariat. Is this over? Do we have a new champ?
Not yet.
That
so
is
good.
The heart of a champion.
Yeah.
So good.
Butch has him up.
Nice.
Oh, driver.
Big driver. Oh. And Thatcher's out at two again.
Butch is busting, is he?
Thatcher will not
scratched
quit.
Up.
We've seen this
before. Selbo, I think.
Yeah,
I haven't
got
it. Selbo,
it takes a lot to keep Terry Thatcher down. He spoke about hard.
Nice.
Terry has the title. He wants that title. He's going to keep that title. You're going to take a lot to put him away.
I love that Terry Thatcher's offense is so innovative, do you know what I mean? It just suits his style, his build, his height and everything. Do you know, I love that, like, you couldn't see Bruce Murphy doing that, do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
It's such clever wrestling.
It's just playing to his strengths.
Yeah,
absolutely.
His experience pays off.
Yeah.
Both men must be absolutely smashed out to the outside again, boys. For the second!
Oh, huge dive off
second
the top!
Second time tonight, beautiful. We see Thatcher dive into the outside. Both no men. Kendo stick this time to save Butch, though.
Both men down and out outside the ring. No count outs.
Is that kind of like Jamie Noble vibe off him? Like, you know, when Jamie Noble was on fire, you know, back in the 2000s, like, you know, everybody's like, oh, he's small in stature and he's going to be a high flyer. Like, and he was, you know, he beat the shit out of most people he was in the ring with whenever he was going in with fucking JBL and getting squashed for no reason. Like, but
there's method to the madness, like, isn't there?
He was just so good at it doing it. And you can see, like, where Jamie Noble's been now. Like, he's been backstage, you know, producing matches for WWE 3 years after, like. Just psychology is ridiculous.
Yeah.
He's got another candlestick.
Fox checking on Terry Thatcher.
He's a human jumping bean, Laura.
He's a human jumping bean.
He's not finished looking for something else. Oh, he's got his towel.
He's got his towel.
Just when we thought the fun and games was over.
Why is he getting his towel? Why is he getting his towel?
Oh, he's choking him!
In it.
How's that for fun and
this
games?
Is perfectly legal in a
it
match
is
like
completely
this
legal.
Oh, he's hanging him.
Love that.
Now.
Love this.
He's hanging him up.
Yeah. Brilliant.
Well, Foxy's
gonna have to stop this.
Step in, surely.
He's hanging him.
Strangled.
What an amazing way to use that tail.
He's out.
Brilliant.
Come on, Foxy.
Oh, yeah, the candlestick. And again. And another.
Terry Thatcher managed to summon whatever morsel of energy has remaining. Butch Armstrong knocked down with three massive smacks of a kendo stick straight to the face.
He's the same knackers for them. Right, you know what I mean? I feel spent for them.
He was looking for a table.
We have a table now.
We have a table.
Terry Thatcher is superhuman.
I have the table. Best thing ever.
Guys, this kind of stuff, things get worrying.
I think Butch pissed Terry off.
At this point, this is a battle of wills. Who wants it more? Who's willing to sustain this output and take the most amount of
awesome
punishment?
Was that our first? Did you get one of them before?
I don't remember.
Not sure.
Like, there was an attempt at one before, like, but it didn't pick off.
People are so
that onto the table, right?
Yeah.
So those two legs underneath it. Like, that's wood and steel. Like, that's sore.
Yeah.
Still in this, I don't
like,
know.
There's no, there was no give on that at all. Like,
we've seen
and they're thick fucking steel legs.
Yeah,
are,
yeah.
Like the WWE fucking flimsy ones that bend like fucking a tin can. Like, these are
huge
proper steel legs.
That
the echo.
That table set up in the corner very precariously.
Look how thick the legs are.
I don't like this at all.
Much have in mind here. Butch has Thatcher up.
This is going to be.
He's going to throw him through the table. He has him up in a crucifix.
Well.
No, Butch. Oh! Thatcher gets a super kick.
And it's
Oh
my God!
To the table.
Butch is deceased.
When you see the table hit him in the face.
The sound of that impact.
And the back of it.
The echo. That put through Dolan's live in person.
Yeah.
A lot louder than
the
it was.
The noise, like, was off.
Fucking wicked.
Butch Armstrong has to kick out that. And he's locked in.
He's locked in
a chokehold.
He has it.
Does he have it?
No way. He's got it. Oh,
he's
gone for the stick. Going for the stick.
Is he going to tap?
I'm so into this match.
They're viciously locked in.
Looking for the ropes, but there's no rope break. He's got the kendo stick.
There's no rope break in a match like this.
Yeah!
He has him choking with the kendo stick.
What a visual. What a visual.
Ridiculous.
He tapped.
Thatcher. Terry Thatcher retains.
What?
Huge love for that match.
Unbelievable. Undisputed. Hard Knox Wrestling. Champion.
Thatcher still thinks the match is going on. He's still in fight mode.
What an amazing
match.
That's
unbelievable.
Best match Hard Knox has ever put on.
Yeah.
Wow.
So far.
Yeah, you said it, Laura. What a show. What a match. What a show. Unreal.
Definitely get there, Laura, if you can, in person.
Yeah.
Witness it in person.
That is what
phenomenal.
You need that level of heart, that level of commitment to come out on top. That was
unbelievable.
Devastating.
That was the best match.
Even how he landed it going through the table.
Yeah, so clean.
A night full of debuts, but a night never to be forgotten for Terry Thatcher. He retains his world title.
Just locking in that candlestick around the neck. Oh, so good.
Are we going to see round two? What a performance from Butch Armstrong. Butch, did Butch apologize?
He said sorry.
He said, I'm sorry, I had to.
I had to.
And it proved to himself that he was worthy.
Proved that he could hang.
If you want to beat Terry Thatcher for the Hard Knocks Pro Wrestling
run, and like, Thatcher said it. Thatcher said it, like, when I interviewed him, like, I want you to bring it. I want you to bring everything that you have. Because you're going to have to. You know, and...
But look at what this sets Butch up for now as well, like you've seen a whole other side of Butch.
Definitely puts him into that next bracket.
Oh, yeah. Time.
Butch Armstrong stepped up tonight. Butch stepped up. He got in there and he had that vicious type of match. And Butch Armstrong did everything humanly possible to try and beat Terry Thatcher for the Hard Knocks Pro Wrestling title. He showed the heart of a champion, showed everything possible to be a champion. Props to this man. Props to this man.
Take it in, Terry. Take it in.
Terry Thatcher up on the balcony now, celebrate. Back from where he came from at the start of this match. I don't think I'll ever forget the start of this match. That dive from up and up, out of nowhere.
Back where he started.
Boom.
I love it. Oh my God. I got another set of goosebumps there now for that.
What a night. Unbelievable here in Dolington, Limerick. Terry
Thatcher. Oh yeah, if you can, Dara, do.
Sammy D, our number one contender. What about a match is from me, Colin, from Mark, from Cherry. This has been Hard Knocks, where Hard Knocks hits different. Thank you for joining us here tonight, and we'll see you at the next one.
Kill pieces.
Look, there we go. Look, there's the casino theme.
You gotta mute that, don't you?
Wow. This music.
Not that they'd probably mute it, I know. I don't know how it would work. How does it work on YouTube now if we were to put this on YouTube? Like, would they?
You'd have to
mute it. I will see. It tells you when you're uploading if there's a copyright on it. Like.
Yeah.
That's the good thing about YouTube. We'll actually tell you before you actually put it live.
Yeah.
But yeah, my God, what a show. What an absolute great show. Like.
Unbelievable. Class. What a show. Sickened I wasn't there, but delighted that I got to watch it. Like, unbelievable.
Yeah.
Best show they've put on so far. And the other two were bangers as well, but this was just crazy.
It was just good watching it back there. It was just like watching a whole new show again, even though we were there. Like,
oh, not only a good show, CJ, it was everything fantastic. So good.
Everything was so, you know, it was so smooth. Everything flowed perfectly. There wasn't any, there was nothing bad on the show at all. Like, there was nothing really mad. You know, you could have done without that. Everything had a purpose and made sense. It was brilliant.
But it just gets better and better each time.
Mm-hmm.
Do you know what I mean? It's just so tight. Like, it just gets better and better each time. Cannot wait for July.
Yeah.
Oh my God. I can't wait to see what's going to be announced for that.
Long wait for the next show, like, but it's going to
be. It is. But, like, I mean, the build up now. I mean, I'm already buzzing for it after watching that.
Well, they've already got
so.
Raven and LJ announced.
Yeah.
There's tag team tournament happening.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And Terry will be defending again, and whether it's Sammy D.
Presumably, we're going to get Terry and Sammy, but to be confirmed, that would be my guess. But I don't know. Just because Sammy's the number one contender doesn't mean that he's fighting at the next show. Is it going to be a couple of shows down the line? Like, we don't know. Like, watch this space, I suppose. But unbelievable show.
Yeah, great show altogether.
Yeah, hopefully get this up on YouTube now as well. But yeah, sick you missed it, Liz.
Disgusted, but come here, I tell you now, come hell or high water, God help us, hopefully everything's alright going forward, but you get me there.
you just get me there, mate, or you bring the ring to wherever I am and you tell them all to come down, because I do not want to miss this. Missing that was hard enough, but I do not want to miss the next one. No way. I will be there. Full casino ensemble.
Missing.
Charging to take pictures like one of those girls on the strip in Las Vegas. Charging to get pictures taken just for the crack. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Unbelievable. I can't wait for the next one. Like, it's too far away. It's too fucking far away. That's Leon's fault, by the way. I don't care. If he gives out to me, it's Leon's fault. There was only one day available in June and he has a wedding. I told him he should have just not gone to the wedding. Like,
yeah, it's...
He needs not priorities, me. Leon. Like, priorities.
Not your wedding.
Absolute cheek.
Yeah. Cheeky
people. I know, but July, end of July, and then I think... I don't know if I'm allowed to say it. I don't give a fuck. I think they're planning on going again in August.
Oh, really?
So,
so hopefully not a big wait till the next one again. I don't know what's booked.
Not the same
ever,
weekend.
Not the same weekend at all.
Oh, Jesus, it better not be.
No,
I don't think they will. Maybe the weekend of your birthday.
A week later.
That's not funny at all. Now, Kamira loves me some Hard Knocks, right? But I'm just saying.
I don't think it'll be a week later.
Only one star that weekend, and it's me.
Yeah, I think the only place that they potentially could go would be, because AEW is on the 27th, isn't it?
Yeah. Say the 20th.
So the 20th, or if not, then they'd have to go September, maybe. So.
We'll see.
But yeah, exciting times. A lot to happen. We're gonna have new tag champs soon as well.
The belts. If that's the design, it looks
love
ridiculous.
Them.
Yeah, nice belts. So yeah, buzzing for it. Absolutely buzzing. But I think I was worried that the show wasn't going to be as good watching it back. You know, when you're in the moment, you're like, is it just because I'm here? Is it just the feeling of the night? Like, but no, definitely it's stacked up watching back. But I enjoyed it. You guys enjoyed it. Liz enjoyed it. First time seeing it.
Hugely.
But yeah, thanks for watching, guys. Hopefully we'll have more of these in the future. Just before we go, please go over and subscribe to the Hard Knocks YouTube channel again. Yeah. They did us a massive favor, letting us stream this. So obviously they're giving up views for people to be able to watch it through us. So thank you very much to Steve Leon, for letting us do it. And get over to our socials as well. Irish Wrestling Entertainment. Jerry works very hard on social media, to keep the content going out, taking over. So all of our links are on our profile page there on Twitch, if you want to hit that. And hopefully we'll get this up on YouTube, so people who couldn't join us tonight live will be able to join us on YouTube to watch the show with us.
If you're watching this on YouTube or you're still tuned in, you know, leave your comments below if you want to enter the competition as well for the two tickets. Hard Knock show.
Absolutely. And hopefully we'll have more of these in the future. We have a few plans to do a few things, so watch this space again. So thanks very much for joining us, everybody.
See ya.